went all access with Kansas. A season ago, Kansas started 5-0, took college football by storm, hosted game day, then a little bit of a reality check. They lost 6 of their last 7, still made a bowl game, and in a wild game where Jalen Daniels set the school record for passing yards, came up a little short against Arkansas, 55-53. Paul Carcaterra last year getting to a bowl game, that has been a springboard in so many ways.
Well, Anish, everyone knows Kansas as a basketball school, but things are changing. The football program is on the rise, and the investment from the school is real. Lance Leipold, the head coach, was courted by a bunch of other schools in the offseason, but decided to stay and signed an extension through 2029. The school also committed $300 million to the Gateway District project, which includes massive renovations to the football operations building, the locker room, the weight room, and the stadium. Lance Leipold told me he believes Kansas can be a basketball and football school, and these investments show they can compete and hang with anyone.
He's got some style. That hoodie that he had, that short sleeve hoodie, Cark's got to get us one of those, baby.
Andre, this crowd speaks to what Cark was talking about. You have not seen these type of crowds for a long time at Kansas. It started last year. Yeah. The success Lance Leipold had, him to Brett Bielema's credit, he's helped resurrect Illinois after a 10-year downturn.
As you get closer to the weekends in the fall, this is now the place to be at a Kansas football game.
Kansas won the toss, elected to defer. Illinois will run it out of the end zone. Aiden Lawfery out of bounds near the 30-yard line, and the Fighting Illini will go to work on offense first. They're led by their quarterback, Luke Altmyer, transfer from Ole Miss, started last week against Toledo, just his second career start. And Andre, that game turned in the second half when Altmyer took over.
Yeah, it really did. They cut him loose, let him go in the passing game. All he did was go 69%, 206 through the air, and then 2 touchdown passes. He did have the interception, but led him right down the field for the field goal that actually put him ahead to stay with 5 seconds left in the ballgame.
He hands off to Reggie Love on first down, who loses 2 on the play. Illinois obviously has big holes to fill in the backfield. You lose a Chase Brown, one of the top rushers in the country. It's a by-committee approach on the ground to begin the season.
Yeah, it's kind of tough to run against these big guys, Phillips and Dunn, right there in the middle at defensive tackle.
Back to the ground, back to Love, and he finds a little seam across to the 35. Pickup of 7 on the play. It sets up 3rd down.
This Kansas defense, they were stingy in week 1 on the ground. Only gave up 74 yards, and we know that Illinois, with a Brett Bielema coach team, they're going to have a good offensive and sound offensive line. They want to run the football.
For Kansas, the big question on defense is, can they improve on that side of the ball? That cost them games last year. The tight end Ryman goes in motion. Altmyer's first pass attempt, eluding the pursuit. This is what he does well. His throw high and incomplete. 3 and out goes Illinois.
And Brian Borland, the defensive coordinator for Kansas, brought a little pressure. He's got to be proud of his group as well, of getting home, forcing Altmyer out off this launching point, and then going 3 and out, getting themselves off the field, kind of passing the test, so to speak, Anish, on this first drive.
Trevor Wilson will return the punt. Hugh Robertson, the 30-year-old Australian, one of the oldest players in college football, to kick for Illinois. Wilson lets this bounce, fields it off, big hop, and devoured immediately. 46-yard kick, no return.
Excellent, though, to field it, because it was going to bounce and end up inside the 10-yard line. Saved him about 10 yards of field position.
Nikario Harper right there for Illinois, and Kansas will go to work on offense, and it's Jason Bean who comes out first, not Jalen Daniels. And Daniels is out there as well, so right away, Bean led the offense out, Daniels is on the field, both quarterbacks are out there, and now...
Oh, with Bean in, they certainly can throw it, and maybe even a second time, a little lateral.
How about both quarterbacks? Who's taking the snap? It's Daniels, little zone read, quick release, he gets rid of it and completes to Lawrence Arnold. So, you gotta love that. We know Kansas pre-snap, it's a trip to Amsterdam. Eye candy and window dress, and a lot of it.
I absolutely love the look of both quarterbacks with their hands up as if they're taking the snap. You don't know who's getting the football. Well, Jalen Daniels, preseason Big 12 Offensive Player of the Year. He was magical at the end of the season last year.
Skinner, little orbit motion, so you got a wishbone set out of the spread. It goes to Skinner, and he's out of bounds across the 30 for a pickup of two.
Wait, you got to watch this Kansas offense closely. You're going to see a lot of personnel groupings, a lot of different formations, a lot of motions, as you like to call it, the eye candy.
I call it Amsterdam.
Yeah, trying to trick up the defense a little bit, get a guy out of position, and then that's when the big plays start to happen.
Skinner motions, Daniels moves the pocket, throws downfield, on the run, complete, it's Arnold. And he's into Illini territory, a gain of 22.
Boy, it looked initially like nobody was open. And then all of a sudden, Lawrence Arnold, Daniels stays with it. Arnold presents himself in an accurately thrown football. Big play for Kansas, and they move it up for a first down.
On the ground at Devin Neal, the top returning rusher in the Big 12. 1,000-plus yards last season. He's to the 45. Andre, last year, when you think of all the great quarterbacks in college football, Bryce Young, Caleb Williams, the Heisman winner, Drake May, Hendon Hooker, C.J. Stroud, Jalen Daniels had the highest QBR of all of them.
Yeah, and it's just that Kansas doesn't get maybe the pub that the others are getting, but he's certainly getting the recognition here early in the season.
The gun, Daniels hands it off, and Neal upended, the ball is out, recovered by Kansas, and Dougie Million, it'll bring up a third down, a gain of three on the play.
He was hit right on the football, right on it, and it looked as though Neal was having some problems putting it away, stumbled, couldn't get his balance, and
all of a sudden injury.
It's Scott that comes up with a big hit. Got an injured Illinois player down on the field.
Pacifico is brewed for those who let go of the things that don't matter and hold on to the ones that do. That's living life anchors up.
Subway refreshed everything, and now they're slicing their deli meats fresh. That's why the new Subway Series subs are preferred by this QB.
And preferred by his old backup QB.
And if we prefer it, we know you'll prefer it too. Have you been behind me this whole time?
Yep.
This wasn't no bear. It was like a bear squatch.
Dad, what's a bear squatch?
It's a cross between a bear and a sass. It's made up. He's usually sleeping.
He'll never sleep again.
MLB chooses T-Mobile for Business for 5G solutions to not only enhance the fan experience, but to advance how the game is played. Now's the time to see what America's largest 5G network can do for your business.
Let's unretire.
Why, Matt?
What do?
Let's go!
I'm good right here, bro.
At Domino's, our newest stuffed cheesy bread is loaded with pepperoni. Frankly, we're kind of embarrassed we didn't think of adding pepperoni sooner. But better late than never? Try irresistible new pepperoni stuffed cheesy bread. It's the perfect mouth-watering side for pepperoni lovers. Only at Domino's.
If you have heart disease and are on a statin, lowering cholesterol can be hard.
diets and exercise add to the struggle. Today, it's possible to go from struggle to cholesterol success with Leqvio. With a statin, Leqvio is proven to lower bad cholesterol by over 50% and keep it low with 2 doses a year. Common side effects were injection site reaction, joint pain, urinary tract infection, diarrhea, chest cold, pain in legs or arms, and shortness of breath. Ask your doctor about twice yearly Leqvio. Lower, longer Leqvio.
The cost of home ownership has been a struggle. Utility prices rising. Sweetie, can you practice that somewhere else?
Well, the good news is new customers who bundle and save with Progressive save over 20% on average.
Sorry, she's just really good at that.
The fact that this Reese's ad showed up at this exact moment proves that your devices are listening to your stomach.
This is a story that takes place every Saturday. There's magic rocks, wild animals, techno, and rivalries that go back decades. This story has everything. Want to hear it?
Xavier Scott was the injured Illinois player. He's the one who forced the fumble on Neal. That was the last play before we went to break. It's 3rd down and 4 for Kansas. And this could very well be 4 down territory.
And he's important to their defense. Best slot cover man that they have is Xavier Scott.
Currently on the sideline. Swing pass to Neal. He's got room in the flat. Down the sideline and bumped out of bounds near the 20-yard line by Miles Scott, the converted wide receiver who had a pick six last week in his first game playing defense.
Yeah, Miles Scott just continues to get better. Just an athlete. As you mentioned, moved over from wide receiver to free safety. Started out as a corner, moved to the back end, and he just makes plays back there. Talking to Aaron Henry, their defensive coordinator, yesterday, he just said, hey, we are totally blown away at the progress that Miles Scott has made.
Kansas will empty it out. Daniels looking for 6, incomplete. Wanted Torrey Loughlin.
And had him matched against the linebacker. Exactly what you want. He's the best receiver, a very athletic, excellent receiver out of the backfield. And had him matched against the linebacker. Just what you want if you're their offensive coordinator.
Andy Kotelnicki, Kansas offensively returns the most firepower of any team in college football.
10 starters back this year for the Jayhawks.
Neal, changing direction.
What a move.
And upended as he gets inside the 20. Leighton Bush, the safety with the tackle. 3rd down.
He gave it to Ryan Meade. Just stuck his left foot in the ground and forced the outside linebacker inside, and then he was off to the races. Nice job there by Neal. Big part of this offense. Rushed for a career high last year of 224 yards on 32 carries, so more than capable of carrying the load.
Fairchild, the tight end. Motions one. Throw. Complete. It's Luke Grimm, and he is dragged down inside the 10. They're going to get a face mask.
And yeah, Ryan Meade.
Multiple flags down. 1st and goal, Kansas, and they're going to get closer.
Well, all of a sudden, I think Andy Kotelnicki, the offensive coordinator, has found some matchups that he
during
likes.
The run, personal foul, face mask, defense number 34. That penalty will be half the distance to the goal, automatic 1st down. The receiver can stay in the game. Since his helmet came off due to a foul.
They're targeting Ryan Meade, which now Illinois has taken him out of the game. But the play before, it was Neal giving him the dead leg. And then that play, the face mask, another player getting ready to make a nice move on him. Kansas red zone, the last game, they were 4 touchdowns in 6 trips in the red zone.
They had 4 rushing touchdowns by 4 different players in that game. Daniels to the air. He's got Loughlin. Makes the catch.
What a throw.
Touchdown, Kansas.
What a throw. I mean, that ball was in the air before the receiver actually had, the running back had a chance to actually turn his head around. He had to adjust to the football at the last second. That's having some confidence in your arm and the guy that's on the other end of it catching the touchdown pass in Torrey Lockett. Coaching staff told us, hey, he is an excellent receiver out of the backfield. They didn't wait long to go to him.
And he is someone that can line up all over. The extra point is good by Seth Keller. Jalen Daniels making his season debut after not playing last week. How about 10 plays, 82 yards in 4 minutes and change. Lachlan caps the drive with six.
A truck is a tool, but a ram is life. Yeah, it's the wipe the sweat off your brow sort of life. But it's also the let's load up the ATVs life. The my kids play way too many sports life. The let's find a secret spot to fish life. That looks nice. Innovations, comforts, and powertrains built to power all the lives you live. Ram.
You know when a melty grilled cheese sounds so good, but so does a bacony burger with creamy peppercorn ranch. And you couldn't possibly choose, cause brain no work too good when tummy empty. Sonic Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheese Burger Deal for $3.99.
When your child starts getting into everything, you may need a little help. So Duracell created the only lithium coin batteries with a bitter coating to help discourage swallowing.
Why I love Halloween?
Why?
People give me Kit Kats for free.
Son, you're 8. All your Kit Kats are free.
Happy Halloween! Have a break, have a Kit Kat.
GEICO makes car insurance easy.
Enjoy your flight.
You too.
As easy as saying the wrong thing.
Me too. Really?
What?
Dad, why would you say that?
Why would you say that?
Do I look like I'm going on vacation, sir?
It's not how airports work, man.
You could.
Dad.
Are we leaving or?
I don't even want to go on vacation anymore.
I thought I knew you.
She has hairspray that is over the limit.
With an app that puts your policy in your pocket, it's easy to GEICO.
And you're not wearing socks. Get a grip, man.
There are some things that go better together.
Burger and fries.
Soup and salad.
Like your workplace benefits and retirement savings. With Voya, considering all your financial choices together can help you make smarter decisions.
Voya, well planned, well invested, well protected.
How irresistible are Cheez-It crackers?
Uh-oh! Want it, need it, Cheez-It.
My store, my design business,
we're exploding. But my old internet was not letting me run the show.
So we switched to Verizon Business Internet.
They have business-grade internet nationwide.
Make the switch. It's your business. It's your Verizon.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Ram Trucks and in part by Sonic 399 Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheeseburger for a limited time only at Sonic.
Is it possible to think of anything besides football when you hear the name Butkus
or Red Grange? That's one of the few autographs I have of Dick with Dick Butkus on a program when I was at Illinois a long time ago. He signed it, was at the game, and I've held on to it. Don't have many, but I've got that one.
One of the all-time greats. You can make the case he's the greatest linebacker who ever played the game of football.
Well, you got a few in there. A lot of guys who make a case.
Certainly for his era.
Ray Lewis and Lawrence Taylor.
Illinois will start at the 25-yard line Saturday night, 7 o'clock on ESPN. Top 10 matchup in Tuscaloosa, Texas and Alabama. Steve Sarkisian goes, who you got, Tuscaloosa? I think the Tide win. Texas didn't look that impressive in that win against Rice last week. Sark, OC in 2020 for the championship team. And, hey, the SEC in week one, for all the might of the SEC, LSU lost, Florida lost, South Carolina lost.
Yeah, tough weekend, but That's going to be one heck of a game. I think Texas will play better than you think, but I'm going with Bama as well at home.
Altmaier does not find an escape route. He's tackled by Melo Dotson, only a gain of two.
I'll tell you what, a lot of Kansas players around the football, and I mean in a hurry, not a lot of time for Luke Altmaier to survey this field.
Downfield off the hands of Pat Bryant, who had two touchdown catches last week. Dotson in coverage, and early on, Kansas getting some push up front. Brett Bielema told us one of the big keys for him, winning the line of scrimmage, using the muscle that Illinois has in the trenches.
Yeah, and right now, Kansas holding their own, so it's forcing Illinois to go to the air a little bit here. Melo Dotson in excellent coverage on that last play. Has a lot of experience in the secondary for Kansas. What a big third down here for Illinois if they're going to get any kind of traction and momentum.
Altmaier down the seam.
What a catch.
And caught. Griffin Moore, the tight end, the fifth-year senior.
Well, and a former high school quarterback, and they told us has excellent hands and body control. That play, he displayed both. Just the concentration to stay with it and the body control to reel that baby in. That's a big play for Illinois on third down.
And a flag against Illinois.
Just making it tough. When you go on the road, it's tough enough to win on the road in a crazy environment like this, but you got to have to continuously overcome penalties. It's tough.
What you just said, Andre, though, in many years past, that has not been applicable to this place.
No.
Noise, tough road atmosphere. You didn't talk about Kansas that way.
But, you know, this group of players, this group of this coaching staff, hey, we had nothing to do about it in the past. We're concentrating on right now.
Good coverage again by Dotson on Bryant.
But another free runner on the quarterback, and that makes you just tense up just a little bit, and all of a sudden you see the ball go high. He hadn't had a clean pocket where he could just deliver the ball cleanly since this game kicked.
It's a Kansas defense that is replacing its entire front four.
If I'm Altmaier right now, Anish, I'm thinking blitz. I'm going to get some pressure from someone.
Well, keep it on the ground. This is Josh McCray. Logan held him up before he was finished off. A nice run there by McCray. He and Love got the majority of the carries, split almost evenly last week as they try to find an answer in the run game with Chase Brown in Cincinnati.
Yeah, McCray got himself into the end zone. A thick, physical guy, downhill runner. Most of these backs, Love, McCray, Fagan, and Lotterdy, they're all kind of downhill types.
Four-man twist. Altmaier in trouble. And down he goes. Wow. Sacked by Patrick Joyner, the grad transfer out of Utah State.
When you have a defense that starts to match the offense, then you have a special football team. Look at the coverage down the field. Tight coverage, nowhere for Altmaier to go. So he's dealing with pass rush and tight coverage. That spells advantage defense.
You play that position, that's not fun.
No, it's frustrating, and you're just trying, hey, give me some separation. Big guys up front, give me another second or two. Give me another kick to get this ball out.
Wilson signals for a fair catch and makes it inside his own 15. A 42-yard punt. Kansas ball. They went 10 plays, 82 yards for a touchdown the first time they touched it.
Texas, Alabama, Saturday at 7 on ESPN.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Picking up the Duralast brakes I ordered online this morning.
Right now, you can save 15% when you buy a set of Duralast pads with rotors.
We've never been good at keeping secrets, like how Sonic's new bacon peppercorn ranch grilled cheeseburger with small fries or tots is just $3.99. Oops, burger's out the bag. Sonic bacon peppercorn ranch grilled cheeseburger deal for $3.99.
What do we always say, son? Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance.
They only pay for what you need.
That's my boy. Stay off the freeways.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels. Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
BK Royal Crispy Wraps. Eat it with the meal or have it as a snack. Only $2.99. It's a hunger hack and it fits in one hand.
At BK, have it your way.
This is not the first all-electric car. That's because no BMW sees the road until it's reached the ultimate standard, our own. A standard that demands that every BMW drives and feels exactly like a BMW should. Unparalleled performance and precision handling made possible by electric engineering. But isn't that what you'd expect from the ultimate electric driving machine? Build your own all-electric BMW iX today.
The future. The way you see it is said to depend on where you sit. At X-Chair, we think it also gets down to how you sit, which is why our technology is light years ahead. X-Chair has done it again with our groundbreaking LMX technology, providing hours of infinite comfort no matter where in the world you're sitting. By synthesizing the universe's elements, bringing hot, cold, and touch into one extraordinary seating experience, our mission is to help you discover that every workday can happen with body and mind in an out-of-this-world place of comfort and productivity. X-Chair is charting a new course, helping workers everywhere find comfort as their work worlds zoom back and forth. Even though your work reality may continue to shift, we've got our eye on the future of work so you can focus on the present. And from where we sit, the future still feels good. Save up to $300 and revamp your workspace during X-Chair's Labor Day sale. Ends September 12th.
Seven nothing Kansas on top of Illinois. Kansas's offensive coordinator Andy Kotelnicki told us he wants to be the most stressful offense in the country. How did they do it on the
first? Well, you do it with balance, and they went to the air early. A nice completion to Lawrence Arnold. Then they come back, they go to the ground to Devin Neal. He's making plays, losing defenders, and then the touchdown pass to Tory Loughlin in the corner of the end zone, spreading you out, going to the ground, to the air. It's clicking on all cylinders for Kansas offensively.
They come out in a two tight end set. And again, a lot of moving pieces. Had an open receiver. It was Neal on the wheel route, incomplete.
You know, he missed that one, Jalen Daniels. But keep in mind, he didn't play last week against Missouri State. He's nicked up in camp. But watching him in pregame, every movement that he makes is smooth. I mean, his arm release, the way that he moves his feet. He's one of those athletes, Andre. He just makes everything look easy on the sideline.
Man, no doubt about it, Clark. I mean, he is smooth as they get. I mentioned it at the top, just a dual threat guy that can make plays with his legs. We have yet to see that. He's certainly making them with his arm.
Speed option, pitch to Loughlin. And pushed out of bounds by Seth Coleman, only a yard on the play. Andre, I know you like 49 and White Coleman. He's part of that stout front seven.
Yeah, he along with Atkins on the other side, two outside linebackers that can get after you. But Coleman, he can play all linebacker spots. They tell me he is versatile as any player on this defense. Athletic ability, just he's got tons of it. And fast, quick, off the edge, one of their better pass rushers.
Third down, 9 to go. Let's see if Illinois brings pressure. They've got a one-high safety look. Here comes the pressure. Daniels eluding the pursuit. He's got a lot of room to run. And he slides for a first down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 17.
When he loses, they bring the pass rush. Illinois gets home, but you got an athlete playing quarterback in Jalen Daniels. Or a quarterback that has a ton of athletic ability, and when it parks and you're in man-to-man coverage, there's nobody accounting for the quarterback, and he just took off obvious first down there for Kansas.
And a nice job by the running back there, Andre, picking up that blitzer.
nice. You got unselfish players and guys that don't mind doing the dirty work, you're going to have some success offensively.
They reward Highshaw, picked up the blitz on the last play, and he bowling balls his way for a first down, a gain of 11. Miles Scott again making the tackle, and Kansas continues to move the chains. Illinois defensively, they had three defensive backs last year taken in the first three rounds. Devin Witherspoon, the marquee, went fifth overall to Seattle. You also lose your D coordinator. Ryan Walters left to take the head coaching job at Purdue. He took linebackers coach Kevin Kane with him. So Aaron Henry, promoted from DB's coach, is the new D coordinator, as Daniels keeps for a nice pickup.
They have been, kind of choosy when they run Jalen Daniels, 6 yards per rush for this Kansas offense. But he's had that back stiffness and tightness leading into this game. Caused him to miss last week in their season opener against Missouri State. But they're going to be kind of careful with him in terms of how much they actually run him in this game.
That's been the one knock on him in his career, health. Mm-hmm. Clean pocket. Launching downfield. A lot of contact.
No flag.
No flag. Yes, Skinner was the target. Xavier Scott in coverage.
And I think maybe because the ball was thrown out of bounds that the officials didn't even think about throwing the flag here. Nice to see Xavier Scott back in the game, but holding and pulling and still no flag. I may have run all the way down there to that spot if I'm in the game trying to champion for a pass interference or at the least a holding call.
Instead, third and five. Kansas perfect on third downs. They were number one on third down conversions in the Big 12 last year, and they go to old reliable Luke Grimm. Last year, more than 60% of Grimm's catches resulted in a first down or a touchdown.
Yeah, they're glad to have him back. He's been nursing an ankle, but he runs a little jerk route where he starts inside and goes back out, leaves every Illini defender inside. It's an easy throw and catch between Jalen Daniels and Luke Grimm.
Kansas has three tight ends on the field, but they're in a spread formation. And they run speed option. Neal accelerates inside the 30, another first down. And you start to look at these plays. I mean, nothing cheap about this. This isn't 4 or 5 yard, 3 yard dink and dunks. These are chunk plays now.
And they were giving up, like, I think, a bunch of plays of 15 or more yards last week, Illinois against Toledo. Wanted to shut that down and keep Kansas from doing that, but it's been big plays, the two possessions that Kansas has had the ball. Big explosive plays by this Kansas offense.
Highshaw gets the call, hit in the backfield, and canceled for a loss back at the 32-yard line. First one to get him was Bryce Barnes.
Get down here, that's where it matters. If you get stingy, the closer a team gets to your red zone, now you're just hoping, if you're Illinois, to hold to a field goal attempt down here. Maybe force the ball out and get yourself a turnover.
Daniels checks down to Neal. The screen, he broke one tackle, lunges forward, an Illinois player lost his helmet. It sets up third down, and now penalty markers after the play.
This may give Kansas a first down, maybe a late hit. Like somebody came into the pile late. Taz Nicholson. Officials are talking to him.
After the play, personal foul, defense number 3. That penalty will be half the distance, automatic first down. And number 28 of the defense has to make for one play for losing his helmet.
And you see Taz Nicholson show up late around the pile, just a little bit too much extra. And they're going to call that type of action every single time. What it does, though, you've had Kansas in third down and long, and it gives them essentially the first down. And now they're at work inside the red zone with a fresh set of downs here.
Kansas has more than 100 yards of total offense than Illinois in the first quarter.
This is where you got to be on alert for Jalen Daniels. They start to spread you out.
Quarterback draw. Look at the splits on the line. Highshaw gets the call. Broke the tackle attempt by Randolph and charges down to the 6-yard line.
These penalties are killing Illinois. Same case last week. 9 penalties for 90 yards kept Toledo in that game. And Andre, you mentioned keeping Kansas drives alive.
Yeah, that's exactly what's happening, especially that last one, Cart. And then now, yeah, you get down here inside the red zone. There's a lot at their disposal when you have an athletic quarterback like Jalen Daniels.
And again, Andre, look at the splits on the offensive line for Kansas.
Better blocking angles when you're in the run game.
Highshaw finding a crease, takes it inside the 5. He's going to be a little shy of the marker, so third down, about a yard to go.
And they can still pick up a first down at about the 8-9 yard line. So you got to keep that in mind. They don't need to score here on third down. Just a yard or two, and they're going to have another fresh set.
3 tight ends into the game for Kansas.
This is impressive. 2 drives, you march it down, you got an opportunity for points again if you're Kansas.
This will be the 13th play of the drive. Daniels to the air, end zone, caught for a touchdown. It's Jared Casey.
The Swiss Army knife is what the coaching staff told us. They'll line him up everywhere. Found him in space, and the timing of the throw by Jalen Daniels tells you he is locked in. Playing at a very high level. That ball was gone before Casey even came out of his break clean. Excellent throw and catch.
Extra point, good. Kansas in this first quarter has had the ball for almost 11 minutes. They went 10 plays, 82 yards for a score. 13 plays, 85 yards for a score on this drive. Right now, they are doing what they want against what is, on paper, a very good Illinois defense.
Most defensive coordinators will tell you they prefer, hey, well, you think you can go 13 plays on us? Let's see it without making a mistake. And that's exactly what Kansas has done. 2 drives in a row. I think it's the experience of the quarterback. It's moving the ball around to multiple players on the offensive side of the ball. And then the success in the passing game with Jalen Daniels has been automatic for Kansas.
And just the amount of looks they have given this Illinois defense.
Looks, motions, all of them.
The wide splits, multiple tight ends, misdirection. Now the first offensive snap for Kansas. You had 2 quarterbacks in the shotgun, each with his hands out waiting for a snap.
I mean, that's tough. You don't know which one's going to take the snap. Bean is, he would start for a lot of teams around the country.
This Saturday on ESPN Plus, you got number 17, Oklahoma, against ACC-bound SMU. LSU looking to bounce back from the Florida State loss. They host Grambling State. TCU fell to Colorado. You may have heard a whisper or two about that game. The Horned Frogs, last year's national runner-up, get Nicholls State in Fort Worth.
Boy, all home team wins. Looking at that graphic. Just take every home team in that of the 3.
Not giving SMU a chance.
At Oklahoma, not how they looked last week.
There's Reggie Love. And he fights forward across the 30 out to the 32-yard line. Gain of 7 on the final play of quarter number 1. 40,000 plus at Memorial Stadium. Jared Casey turned into a local legend when he had that game-winning two-point conversion catch against Texas a few years ago. That catch made it 14-0.
Pandemonium, it's showtime. Got their noses up, I know why.
Interesting piece. Let me bring in my expert.
So many scratches.
Those are from my car keys.
Such a rich history. This won't do well at auction, but at AT&T, it's worth a brand new Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 5.
Wait, really?
Mm-hmm.
What about this?
AT&T's deal is back.
Wow.
Everyone gets a free new Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 5 with a Galaxy phone trade-in. Any year, any condition.
Reese's. They'll get you. They will get you good.
KFC chicken nuggets?
Chicken nuggets?
KFC chicken nuggets! Chicken nuggets!
KFC chicken nuggets!
Chicken nuggets?
It's dinner time. Get KFC original recipe chicken nuggets. 10 pieces for just $5.
Let's unretire.
Why not?
Let's see!
Hey. I need that senior discount.
I'm good right here, bro.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Picking up the Duralast brakes I ordered online this morning.
Right now, you can save 15% when you buy a set of Duralast pads with rotors.
This necklace is a new piece of my soul.
It is one of my love languages to gift.
I always knew I had a sister, and she didn't. When we met, it was what I longed for my entire life.
Explore our Brilliant Moments collection. Jared, love brilliantly.
Goldfish! Can I get the handful?
Sure.
Happy?
Go for the handful.
Pizza lovers know Marco's is the real deal. Real fresh dough, real signature sauce, three real cheeses topped with real meats. Now get another real deal. Unlimited medium one-topping pizzas for $6.99 each. Marco's. Pizza lovers, get it.
You inspire the Lexus ES to be, well, more you. So thank you. We hope you like your work.
Nice footwork.
Man, you're lucky. Watching live sports never used to be this easy. Now you can stream all your games like it's nothing.
Yes! That's what I'm talking about!
Oh, here he comes!
Yeah!
Running up and down that field looks tough.
It's a pitch.
Get way more into what you're into when you stream on the Xfinity 10G network.
UFC 293, buy it on ESPNplus.com/PPV.
14-0 Kansas as we begin the second quarter here at Memorial Stadium in Lawrence. Great crowd on hand. Kansas wearing the Blackhawk uniforms. First time in school history, black helmets, black shirts, black pants. And Luke Altmyer, the Ole Miss transfer, looking to get Illinois on the board.
To get them going here, you're going to have to vacate the game plan pretty soon.
Reggie Love hammerheads across the 35 for a first down.
And this is to your point, what Brett Bielema told us, that they felt like they could run against the interior portion of this Kansas defense. And so we may see a lot of inside run here from Illinois as they try to settle things down.
Love, the top returning rusher, gets the call again on the cutback. And it sets up a second and about four. In the case of Luke Altmyer, the transfer quarterback, he backed up two pretty good ones in college, Matt Corral and Jackson Dart. As there's an Illinois player down at the left tackle, the green one, Julian Pearl, sixth-year senior who Brett Bielema views as one of the anchors on that offensive line.
A heck of an athlete, too. Played basketball for an elite team when growing up, or in high school as well. So he wasn't always just a left tackle. Got some game on the hardwood.
our ears perked up yesterday when Brett Bielema, who has coached massive, highly talented guys on the offensive line at Arkansas and Wisconsin and other places as an assistant coach, he told us the left side of his line, Pearl, and left guard Isaiah Adams,
as good as he's ever had.
Tackle, best left tackle, left guard tandem he may have ever seen.
Yeah. And that's saying something, is all the those big guys he had down at Arkansas, all the offensive linemen at Wisconsin, that when he was doing his thing there, the backs that ran behind the offensive line, I mean, that's a pretty good compliment. He just bounced Isaiah Adams out the tackle.
Altmaier to the air underneath. That's his second completion. It's Casey Washington in the Toledo game last week. One of the best throws from week one. Fourth down and four, game on the line. Pressure coming. Altmaier gets hit, lets it go. Washington made a contested catch to keep the drive alive. Illinois ends up kicking the game-winning field goal.
Yeah, he's got some really good hands, Casey Washington, and they're looking to actually get him a lot more involved in this game after last week, only catching four passes.
Let's see if they lean on this big offensive line.
Ball got it
out. Kansas says they have it. A lot of confusion.
Actually, they ruled it right back at the line of scrimmage. I thought maybe they'd lost a yard or so.
They did lose a yard. So it's fourth down. The punt team comes on. That was miscommunication, and it cost Illinois a chance at a third down conversion.
Well, it looked as though Illinois was trying to fool Kansas, who was ready for it. I mean, they got off on the snap, tried to snap it to Griffin Moore, and he went nowhere.
Fair catch is made at the 17-yard line by Wilson. Kansas has had the ball twice. They've scored twice. Can Brett Bielema's defense come up with a stop?
Oh, hey.
What are you doing out here?
Letting people know Corona Premier is a light beer.
Oh, it is a light beer.
90 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs.
If only there was a way to tell people.
Whoa.
Corona Premier, wow. Unexpectedly, wow. Light beer.
You know when a melty grilled cheese sounds so good, but so does a bacony burger with creamy peppercorn ranch. And you couldn't possibly choose, cause brain no work too good when tummy empty. Sonic Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheese Burger Deal for $3.99.
My store, my design business,
we're exploding. But my old internet was not letting me run the show.
So we switched to Verizon Business Internet. They have business grade internet
nationwide.
Make the switch. It's your business. It's your Verizon.
The Subway Series menu is getting a new lineup of sandwiches. The Deli Heroes. There's fresh sliced turkey on the Titan Turkey. Fresh sliced ham on the Grand Slam Ham. Five meats on the beef. And look at that double cheese. Try Subway's Tasted Refresh yet.
A truck is a tool, but a ram is life. It's the Let's Load Up the ATVs life. The My Kids Play Way Too Many Sports life. The Let's Find a Secret Spot to Fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 4,000 retail consumer cash allowance on most 2023 Ram 1500 trucks. See your Ram dealer today.
Football is back. Got your new fantasy team name? Check. Grill? Check. Fancy Grill? Check. Troy and Joe? Check. Bro and Bro? Check. All the emotions? All season long? Check, baby.
I sign up for free trials all the time. What I don't do is cancel them. Rocket Money uncovers hidden subscriptions and notifies you when a charge is upcoming. From there, you decide if you want that service. And if not, cancel it right from the app with one tap. Download Rocket Money today.
This is FuboTV. It's a better way to watch live news, shows, and sports without cable. Watch multiple games at once with MultiView. Try free at FuboTV.com.
This season, for every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to the school's general scholarship fund. Thank you, Allstate. With Andre Ware and Paul Carcaterra, Nish Roth, Friday night, Lawrence, Kansas, 14-0, Jayhawks on top of Illinois, Big 12 against Big 10, and Jalen Daniels, who did not play last week due to back tightness, he's been bothered by it through the preseason, has played tonight. Kansas has had it twice. They've scored twice. Daniels chased by Newton and throws it over the head of Vermillion.
Vermillion kind of popped open late, and I think Jalen Daniels had already made the decision he was going to throw it away. Otherwise, he'd drop it down to number five. But just the ability to both run and throw has kept this Illini defense off balance. And Kansas pretty much had their way. Two 80-plus yard drives for touchdowns. Go down and get some points here. It's going to almost just about force Illinois to abandon their game plan and start to sling it around a little bit more.
Luke Grimm was the motion man. Pressure from up the middle, and there is Johnny Newton. He and Randolph pay rent in the backfield. Rent due for Newton here in the second quarter.
Yeah, this young man can flat out just take over a game. Very physical inside player. Goes all out on every snap. I think Jalen Daniels thought he had a little more time than he did. All of a sudden, there's Johnny Newton getting his first sack of the season.
An All-American a season ago. He was tied for first to last year in quarterback hits among Power 5 D linemen. Four-man pressure. Daniels has time. Fires one over the middle. Skinner can't hold on. And Illinois' defense comes up with a stop. Miles Scott was there in coverage. It's fourth down. Kansas will punt for the first time this season.
I'll tell you what, Quentin Skinner, super fast, did everything exactly right except catch the football. I mean, the route, working himself back to the quarterback, down the stem, creating separation, all of it was there for Skinner. He's got to go ahead and corral the football.
Lance Leipold told us this makes him a little nervous. This is the first career punt for the Australian Dylan Graves. It's from his own end zone. He gets it off, and Isaiah Williams with the fair catch. And a chance for Illinois. They will start in Jayhawk territory after just a 37-yard kick.
KFC's $20 fill-up box.
Alexa, play Kentucky Fried Chicken Night.
Oh, yes, it's Chicken Night.
Make it a chicken night with KFC's $20 fill-up box.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Hi, my check engine light's on.
Let's see what our free fix finder service says. And if you need help, we can refer you to a shop.
That's an easy fix.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
These Cheez-It buffs are so cheesy, airy, and puffy. How'd you do it?
With the Puffterizer 5000, anything can be craveably puffy.
Cheez-It Puffed. Defy your cheese-pectations.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels.
They've been told how you feel yourself doesn't matter. Then just like that, they're gone. Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade.
Rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
Domino's new pepperoni stuffed cheesy bread is the best thing since bacon and jalapeno stuffed cheesy bread, which was the best thing since original stuffed cheesy bread. Get Domino's new pepperoni stuffed cheesy bread or any other two or more mix and match items for just $6.99 each at Domino's.
Take a look at this car. It's the one I'm gonna use.
When your
your child starts getting into everything, you may need a little help. So Duracell created the only lithium coin batteries with a bitter coating to help discourage swallowing.
Baby, it's over.
I mean, we both saw this coming.
I'm sorry.
It's Reese's season.
Boo.
The Friday night spotlight shines on Illinois wide receiver Isaiah Williams. On and off the field, others are always first for number one in white. He spent the last two summers coaching boys and girls grades 3-9 for the NFL flag Tuscola 217 United. He told me he was a game changer for seeing the growth in these kids. Many which were shy when they started with him ended up telling him their life stories and confided in him. Also in May, Isaiah actually missed his graduation to be part of a service trip to Kenya with the group Life in Abundance. He spent his time there with underserved tribal communities and gave back by mentoring, encouraging, instilling hope through prayer. He mentioned it was so good and great perspective, and he has an urge to get back there as soon as he can.
You love to see it. You
awesome.
Love to see these student athletes get back. Altmaier on first down finds Casey Washington, who slipped the initial tackle, gets out of bounds. Williams began his career as a quarterback and then made the move full-time to wide receiver in his third season with Illinois. Last year, all he did was catch 82 passes.
26 games with at least one catch. Team's fastest wide receiver. They play him anywhere. And you mentioned the fact he was an excellent high school quarterback who made the switch to wide receiver.
Altmaier ran into his own man and then goes down. Back in Illinois territory, a loss of 6. Jeremy Robinson, that's back-to-back games with a sack for Mr. Robinson.
And he gets by Zy Chrysler, the right tackle who, as you mentioned, Altmaier bumped into him, but it was because Robinson took him there. Took him right to the quarterback and created third down and super long here for Illinois.
Pressure coming, flag down. Altmaier trying to escape. He stumbles across midfield. Penalty marker back at the 43-yard line of Illinois.
Just coming in waves of each.
Make one guy miss, there's two more waiting on you.
Five in the backfield. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
This started with some excellent field position for Illinois after forcing the first punt by Kansas of the season. Unable to do anything with it. The defense rising up for Brian Borland and Lance Leipold, the defensive coordinator and head coach respectively.
You played quarterback as an offense. When your defense holds like that on a short field, what does it do for the offense?
Now we got to go reward them. They did their job. Let's go take care of the defense.
Now this one is downed inside the 10-yard line. A 42-yard punt. Kansas ball deep in its own territory when we come back.
Hi, we're Visible, the wireless company with nothing to hide. Get unlimited 5G data powered by Verizon for $25 a month, every month. Sorry, hidden fees. We're just not into you. Sometimes the choice is just Visible. Switch today at Visible.com.
Auto Quote Explorer from Progressive shows you rates from other companies, even if they're lower than ours.
Because honesty is the best policy. I ate the apple pie you left cooling on the windowsill. That's my bad.
Who are you?
When football was introduced, Arby's and boneless wings weren't a thing. Now they are a thing. And eating $5 boneless wings with fries is the most popular sport in America. Arby's, we have the meat.
I think I'm ready for this.
Heck yeah. With E-Trade, you're ready for anything. Marriage, kids, college.
Kids moving back in after college. Here's to getting financially ready for anything.
And here's to being single and ready to mingle.
Who's ready to cha-cha?
Find your inner flex. With double flex ballroom denim. Only at Duluth Trading.
Here's some straight talk for you. Use your loved ones to save money on wireless.
You could add your favorite son.
You could add your ex.
Add grandma, but don't tell her about the unlimited talk part.
More lines mean more savings with Straight Talk. Get unlimited data, talk, and text for $25 a line.
I'll be there in 30 minutes, I think.
See you there.
I'm moving. Please. Oh, thank you.
Rerouting.
Class-leading safety and tech features to elevate your commute. The all-new Hyundai Kona.
With college football on ESPN+, you get the best teams and the biggest conferences and so much college football action from across the country. So sign up now at ESPNplus.com.
The U.S. Open Women's Championship, tomorrow at 4 on ESPN.
Lance Leipold has worked his way up. He was a five-time D3 national champion at Wisconsin Whitewater, went to Buffalo. His last 3 years at Buffalo represented the high watermark of that program. Now he's got Kansas turned around. And he and Brett Bielema, they were in the same state when Leipold was at Wisconsin Whitewater. Bielema for a stretch was at Wisconsin and a lot of success as well. Three of them there, and then took Arkansas to three bowl games in 5 years. Had a lot of success wherever he's gone, both coaches. Daniels will keep on first down. Into the embrace of a couple of defenders there. No gain on the play. Second down. And knowing what you know about Jalen Daniels and his back problems, just kind of hold your breath every time he runs the football, because you realize just how important he is to this Kansas offense. As they get going in their season at Nevada next week, BYU and at Texas coming up, and I think all games are gettable, especially on the road to Texas. They've gone there before and had success in winning a ball game. And remember, Daniels missed 4 games last year with a shoulder injury. Back and forth by Arnold. Well, I like it. Getting them right back on schedule. Good play call by Andy Kotelnicki, the offensive coordinator, trying to get about half of it to make third down manageable. You hear me all the time talk about quarterbacks. I'd say 90% of them in the NCAA game, they just running plays. Whatever's called, they're just trying to get it spit it out in the huddle and go run it. But guys like Jalen Daniels that actually play quarterback. Kansas tonight, 5 of 6 on third down. Pressure from Newton. Daniels trying to escape. Throws on the run. Downfield, holding! Arnold with a first down across the 35, a gain of 25. That's why he's so special, and that's why he's in the lineup tonight. Jalen Daniels making guys miss, and then the presence of mind to keep his eyes down the field and finding Lance Arnold. They wanted to get him more involved in this game, and Lance Arnold coming to life. And Daniels keeps it going quickly after the big first down. Nice play on first down, just a nice positive game. I mean, this is keeping Illinois on its heels defensively. Well, that last play, you know, before the run, 25 yards, you got Newton in the backfield, an All-American. You're thinking this could be a big play for the Illinois defense. Instead, Daniels extends it. 25 yards, a third down conversion. Play action. Time in the pocket. Now the pressure. Again, he gets away from Newton. Dumps it off to Neal, who is lassoed to the ground by Taz Nicholson. Third down.
Nice job, though, by Illinois in the pass rush because they kind of blinded Jalen Daniels. He had a couple of receivers open over the middle, but he couldn't see them because the pass rush was in his face, and it forced him to drop the ball down to Devin Neal.
Three tight ends here on third down, about two to go. Casey and Fairchild are lined up at the bottom of your screen as receivers. It's not your typical three tight end formation. Daniels running the speed option, fake the pitch, and picks up a first down inside the Illini 45. With his feet, on the move, with his arm, he's done it all tonight.
Yeah, he has done it all, and it's no accident why he was voted as the Big 12 Offensive Player of the Year. He's starting to see and get a taste of exactly why. All the talent in the Big 12 on the offensive side of the ball, this is what people thought he would do this year.
Look what he's done on the money downs.
Unreal.
Option to the right. And Daniels, so slippery, turns that into a positive yard.
Move there just to pick up something. Illinois defensively stringing him out and forcing him to go laterally, not allowing him to turn up or basically keeping the ball in his hands to not allow the pitch to happen either.
Andre, he's now run it seven times. Is that number a little too high for you from my liking, where he's come from?
And especially the success that he's having in the passing. Offensive line's giving him time. So if you want those plays, go ahead and throw it quickly and let the ball get out of his hands into someone else's hand. Don't risk him to injury. Right on cue.
Finds one of his tight ends. That's Mason Fairchild, all conference a season ago. 15 more in Kansas inside the Illinois 30.
Six touchdowns last year for Fairchild. That tied for the team lead. The big kind of do-it-all. Excellent blocker, good receiving tight end. Big and strong at the point of attack.
5th-year senior, he had a big game against Oklahoma last year. Became the first Kansas tight end in 8 seasons to go over 100 yards receiving.
A lot of experience, 3-year starter.
Daniels on the side. In by Wilson with one hand, a pickup of 9. 2nd-and-1, the playbook is open.
What a catch by Trevor Wilson. His one hand snagged that baby. I mean, you got defenders around you. You know you're going to take a shot. But he concentrates just long enough to reel the ball in.
Miles Scott bearing down.
4.0 student, Miles Scott. Smart on the back end. Just made that move from receiver to defensive back.
Here comes Neal. 1st-and-goal, Kansas.
Let's go for a ride, baby. 3 Illini defenders on the back of Devin Neal. Well, we are going to talk about the Jayhawks a lot in 2023.
Jason Bean just came into the game for Kansas.
Out for the trickery here. So both I don't necessarily like it when you get inside the red zone.
Both quarterbacks in the game. Bean is lined up as a receiver. It's a handoff. It's Neal. It's a touchdown for Kansas.
Get you thinking about Jason Bean being offside as a receiver. You start to shift the defense and account for him. What do? Go the other way to Neal. That's genius by Andy Kolonik.
One of the things that Lance Leipold has told us over the years that has worked in Kansas' favor, staff continuity.
Yes.
Andy Kolonik has been with Leipold a long time. So is his defensive coordinator, Brian Borland.
It's because you know what groceries to go and find when you go in the grocery store. The continuity on the coaching staff. Kansas. It's been all Kansas here early. 21-0 Jayhawks.
The beach has always been there for us. As an oasis. Somewhere you can escape to. So it's time we were there for it. That's why Corona's helping clean 100 beaches by 2025. It's the first step in our fight against plastic pollution. To join us, visit coronausa.com.
Businesses need 5G solutions today. That's why they choose T-Mobile for Business. MLB partners with T-Mobile to not only enhance the fan experience, but to advance how the game is played. AAA relies on T-Mobile's network to stay connected nationwide so they can help get their members back on the road. And we're helping Pano AI innovate to stop the spread of wildfires. Now's the time to see what America's largest 5G network can do for your business.
We've never been good at keeping secrets, like how Sonic's new bacon peppercorn ranch grilled cheeseburger with small fries or tots is just $3.99. Oops, burger's out the bag. Sonic Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheeseburger Deal for $3.99.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Picking up the Duralast brakes I ordered online this morning.
Right now, you can save 15% when you buy a set of Duralast pads with rotors.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels. Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
Isn't it absolutely bonkers that you can walk into a store, hand someone a piece of plastic, and they will willingly hand over Reese's Cups? Forget flying cars. This is it. We're at the pinnacle. Try big cups. They're stuffed with more stuff.
KFC's $20 fill-up box.
Alexa, play Kentucky Fried Chicken Night.
Oh, yes, it's chicken night.
Make it a chicken night with KFC's $20 fill-up box.
Goldfish, can I get a handful?
Sure.
Happy?
Go for the handful.
I'm Matt Barry, coming up on the Sling TV Halftime Report. Jalen Daniels and Rockchuck Jayhawk look great. The guys will break down what they've seen out of him, plus the rematch between Alabama and Texas. Sam Acho gives us the key to that game. And we are mulling it over with Dan Mullen. Topics facing teams in week two. We'll see you coming up in just a couple of minutes on the Sling TV Halftime Report.
Last year, guys. Bama, Texas, one-point game in Austin. A little controversial play in the end zone.
I don't know if it's going to be that close to Tuscaloosa this year.
So you are not buying that Texas is back.
The only back I'm buying is Fort Florida State.
Now they look good against LSU week one on that Sunday night. Hey, Monday night. Monday Night Football is back. Bills and Aaron Rodgers and the Jets. 8 p.m. Eastern. You got Peyton and Eli on ESPN2 and ESPN+. Coverage begins with SVP and the new look Monday Night Countdown crew at 6 Eastern. Super Bowl or bust for the Jets?
It seems that way. A lot of hype. A lot of, when they added Dalvin Cook, I think that's when it took them and put them over the top in terms of everybody's expectations.
Not the Rodgers guy?
That had them on pace, but when you added that component to the running game, that did it for me.
Reggie Love picks up five. All right, Illinois, you're down 21-0.
Need a score.
Thought was a very good defense. Is getting picked apart by Kansas. What is the formula for them offensively right now?
Well, I don't know that there is a formula, but they've had some success running between the tackles. Not too late to abandon the running game.
Here's the blitz. Altmyer's got time. Coverage was good. The throw was on target, and Griffin Moore makes the catch to move the chains.
Boy, the blitz pickup by Love gave Altmyer the time necessary to find his receiver, Griffin Moore.
Illinois going quickly. Love goes wide. Altmyer looks his way. Now a tunnel screen. Isaiah Williams stays on his feet and gets across midfield for a first down.
Illinois having some success passing the ball. Kansas has completely controlled the line of scrimmaging, holding Illinois to 33 yards of rushing in the first half. And keep in mind, this is a Brett Bielema team who loves big linemen, loves to run the ball. They're not getting anywhere.
They go to the air. Altmyer gets rid of it quickly. He's got Moore Owen, who barrels his defender right on the sticks. It's another first down for the Illini.
And to Cart's point, they've had some success running between the tackles, actually between the two guards and center, but not much else. So I would not abandon the run. You still have an entire half, but they need some points right here.
And a timeout by Kansas.
Timeout.
1:38 to go in the half.
And the beauty of it for Illinois, they still have all three timeouts. So they can take their time. 1:38, that's an eternity with three timeouts in your back pocket.
Now, Brett Bielema told us he likes to think of his offense as tempro. Cool tempo, a lot of pro style in there. Yes, spread elements, he's adapted. But last week in that game against Toledo, Illinois was down double digits second half. Yes, they got a pick six. But when they were playing at a bit of a quicker pace, it seemed to help the quarterback.
Well, sometimes it takes the thinking out of it for the quarterback. So you're just at the line of scrimmage. You're not, hey, setting protections. You're actually more aggressive that way, where let's call the play and go run and execute it. So it takes the thinking out of it for Altmyer. You may want to think about going to that. And this is the most success they've had all night in their hurry-up offense.
Altmyer, 3 for 3 on the drive, 6 for 9 on the night. Just his third career start. Throwing downfield, underthrown, but caught by Isaiah Williams. First and goal, Illinois.
Purposely underthrown. We call those a fade stop, where you're going to stop the receiver with a back shoulder throw, and it's executed perfectly. Illinois threatening for the first time tonight.
They stick with tempo. Quarterback run. Altmyer gets a block inside the 5.
Well, I think if he cuts outside an inch, he's in the end zone. He cut inside and got bottled up by the umpire right in the middle of the field. Didn't have a place to go. Had he put his right foot in the ground and gone outside, he's walking into the end zone.
We come up on a minute to play this first half. Illinois trying to get on the board.
This will put him right back in the ball game. We're down 14 with the entire second half to play.
Two tight ends in the game. Williams and Bryant, the receivers. Altmyer, end zone. Caught for a touchdown.
Well, jump pass to Tip Ryman.
Number 89.
And just like that, you're back in the game. So what do you think Illinois is going to do in the second half, Anish? A little no huddle, hurry up, get to the line of scrimmage, and just let Luke Altmyer run some plays. That little jump pass to Ryman draws him within 14.
One of the two tight ends in the game. Ryman had 2 catches last week. His first touchdown catch of the season. And Illinois with 41 seconds to go here in the first half on the board, as Ryman, the junior from Rapid City, South Dakota,
indeed,
came to school as a walk-on.
Did they leave the junior quarterback from Lawndale, California, too much time on the clock? 3 timeouts, 41 seconds. My belief is that you can never score too many points in the first half of a football game. So I'm trying to go get points, right, if I'm Lance Leipold.
You speak from memory, because in your case, in that 89 Heisman season, there were a lot of times you knew you weren't playing the second half.
Let's go get
get those numbers in the first half.
Yes, indeed. But if you trust your quarterback, he takes care of the football. And the way he's been dealing in the first half, absolutely, I'm going to cut him loose and try to go get some points here.
And Kansas gets the ball to begin the second half as well. So if you get something here, you could go 2 for 1.
This is a bonus possession for Kansas.
Kick off your week one NFL Sunday at 10 a.m. Eastern with the Countdown Crew on ESPN. How about a John McEnroe, Aaron Rodgers conversation? Plus, a revealing all-access look at Dolphins head coach Mike McDaniel. All that and all the early breaking news, injury updates, and game previews.
That's a good football this weekend.
It is Sunday.
There's going to be a lot of good ones tomorrow and then Sunday. Whew.
NFL back in full force, of course. You know, these parts, a lot of people who were a little on edge this morning after Kansas City fell to Detroit. No Travis Kelce. Tough game for Kadarius Toney. 41 seconds to go. Daniels on first down gives it to Highshaw. Searching for the sideline,
and he got out there,
and he gets out of bounds. Another thing to remember with the new rules in terms of clock, running clock up until the final 2 minutes of each half. So a first down, in this case, would momentarily stop the clock.
Yeah, it's going to certainly stop it with Highshaw going out of bounds. Highshaw going out of bounds, but not having to burn a timeout. That's the drive start that you're looking for. Just pop a run. What happens when they do that, now you can go ahead and open things up and try to aggressively move the ball down the field.
Kansas has had a number of chunk plays in this first half. Daniels backpedaling. Buying some more time. Airs it downfield. He wants Grimm. Contested. And he made the catch.
What a throw. And an even better catch with defenders barreling down on Jalen Daniels. And they don't have to rush to the line of scrimmage. They can just take a timeout here with 23 seconds left.
Now the clock starts after the ball was spotted. Daniels going quickly, looking for the end zone. Incomplete.
Man, I was about to say flag.
And a flag.
Interference. No play on the ball. Tyler Strang. And just like that, here comes Kansas.
Pass interference. Defense, number 20. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
Well, 14 seconds. You still have two timeouts. That's a lot of time for Kansas. You can run the ball. You can throw it. You can bootleg. And the play that sets it all up, he's able to avoid the pass rush by Alec Bryant, and then knowing that he may take a shot, just puts it in the air.
Highshaw, the power back, is the running back. Daniels, design quarterback run, reaching, not going to get there. Second and goal. And the timeout is called with 9 seconds to go.
That's when you have to alert the officials.
Short of the goal line. Timeout Kansas, the second of the half. It'll be 30 seconds.
That if he's short of the goal line, as soon as he's ruled down, we want the timeout. Close to the goal line, but I think the knee touched just before the ball got to the goal line.
So, Andre, you've got one timeout in the bag, which means you can run the football. What do you do here?
I may have thrown it there so I can maximize the opportunities that you have to get it in and not chew up a bunch of time. Taking at least a play away from you when you run it. You got it called quickly, though. Now, remember, they have been running option routes, jerk routes, misdirection type stuff that's fooled Illinois early in the game. Then they go back to one of those.
Daniels now goes wide. Direct snap. It's to the running back, Highshaw, and he powers in for a touchdown.
Wildcat action by Kansas, and they got a player down. Denzel Jackson.
For defensive injury.
Jackson stayed down, but could not keep Kansas out of the end zone with 41 seconds left. Only needed 36 of it to go down and put another touchdown on the board, getting the ball first, as you mentioned, in the second half. Excellent blocking up front, and that was just all Henshaw. Highshaw getting himself into the end zone. Take on those outside defenders and could not keep him out of the end zone.
Hyshaw, a power back. He's battled hip injuries the last two seasons. He was Kansas's second leading rusher as a true freshman back in 2020. And the Jayhawks, you said it, Andre, when they got the ball with 41 seconds to go, they said, hey, two timeouts. This might be too much time. It was.
That can't score too many points in the first half of a game. Let's go get some more. And you have an experienced quarterback like Jalen Daniels, no reason not to.
How surprised are you by what the scoreboard says?
It surprised me because I didn't see this. Illinois, I thought it was an evenly matched game. And I thought this would be, you know, close to tied up going into halftime, somewhere in there. Totally surprised at what's going on right now.
Illinois last week came back in the second half to beat Toledo, the reigning MAC champion. They won on a field goal in the final 5 seconds. Kansas took care of Missouri State a week ago. The Jayhawks have had the ball 5 times in the first half. They've scored 4 touchdowns, and Kansas will receive to begin the third quarter. They have waived a lot of weight tonight in Lawrence.
Tell you what, it's been impressive. Illinois here, kneel it down. Let's get in and talk about it. This touchdown drive for Kansas, amazing, with just needed just 35, 36 seconds to get it done. Look at the drives, though. 10 plays, 82 yards, all drives resulting in touchdowns. 13 for 85, 11 for 94, and that last one, 4 plays, 75 yards, just 36 seconds. When you talk about, they can go high tempo, high octane, or they can methodically move it down the field on you. It's a good football team.
Illinois takes a knee. They'll talk it over at halftime.
And that's the end of the first half.
The Illini will have to figure out how to battle back from 21 down on the road. This isn't your big brother's Jayhawks anymore.
No, not anymore. There's been a precedent set on football and improving facilities, the entire program from top to bottom. I think they're well on their way.
Down to Kark.
Coach, when we spoke this week, you were concerned about their defensive front, a physical bunch. How have you neutralized them?
Well, I think a lot of different looks. We're trying to get ball outside quick. I think our offense is doing a heck of a job of just mixing it up quite a bit. You've seen the ability of Jalen Daniels making some plays when things are kind of broken down. A real good half of football for us holistically.
What does he do for your offense in terms of the complexity?
Well, you can see, I mean, we didn't change too much when Jason was there, but you can see how he keeps plays alive. And what he's doing in the accuracy, he's throwing the ball, and, you know, it's great to have him out there again.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
28-7 Kansas at the half at Memorial Stadium. Now to Bristol and Matt Barry.
Gentlemen, thank you. Time now for the Sling TV Halftime Report. Got some other Friday night football. Indiana and Indiana State. Larry Bird's not walking through that door, but Jalen Lucas is running through that line.
And Indiana State's going to need Larry Bird to come walk through that door and scoring some points to keep up with the Hoosiers.
Lucas again off the right side. Identical play.
Yeah, he was a freshman last year, All-American kick returner, so he's showing off his speed.
Yeah, they played well against Ohio State a week ago. It's all Indiana as you'd expect. With that, welcome in Dan Mullen, Sam Acho, Matt Barry alongside. Rock Chalk, wow. I mean, so far, Jalen Daniels has accounted for 222 total yards. Didn't start last week because of a back. He's made every bit of a difference for KU tonight.
I mean, he's been special. And Coach just said it coming off the field. You know, I mean, he's making plays on his own with his legs, keeping his eyes downfield. It's been pretty special. And when you look at him right now in the first half, it's his ability to not just run and design run. It's moving around in the pocket, keeping plays alive, and the ability to keep your eyes downfield. You get into third and long situations. When you're holding your breath as a coach, scrambling around, running around the end zone. But the eyes are downfield, finding open receivers.
I got a chance to talk to him last year before Big 12 Media Day, and you watch his film. He's a guy who actually wants to throw the ball. He's a reluctant runner, but when he does run, he's dangerous, especially when you're playing against a man-to-man defense like Illinois loves to do. It puts him in an advantageous position.
Right, look at this throw and this effort here. Another example of when you think you've got the quarterback bottled up. He's a coach's worst nightmare. We had talked about it in the pregame show. That's why Nick Saban didn't like quarterbacks that were so mobile, because they present so many problems.
Well, it's the extended play. It's what you're not, you know, as a coach, you're sitting there saying, okay, we're going to defend this play. We have it defended perfectly. And here he goes running around, making things happen on his own, and it drives you nuts.
He has been special to watch in the first half. Kansas all over Illinois. We'll get to the third quarter coming up in just a bit. But first, you may have heard of a game coming up in Tuscaloosa over the weekend. It's the rematch, Bama versus Texas. We'll break it down coming up next in the Sling TV Halftime Report.
This Halftime Report is presented by Sling TV, the college football you love, the live TV you love.
I have type 2 diabetes, but I manage it well. It's a little pill with a big story to tell. I take one daily, Jardiance. At each day start, as time went on, it was easy to see. I'm lowering my A1C.
Jardiance works 24/7 in your body to flush out some sugar. And for adults with type 2 diabetes and known heart disease, Jardiance can lower the risk of cardiovascular death too. Jardiance may cause serious side effects, including ketoacidosis that may be fatal, dehydration that can lead to a sudden worsening of kidney function, and general yeast or urinary tract infections. A rare life-threatening bacterial infection in the skin of the perineum could occur. Stop taking Jardiance and call your doctor right away if you have symptoms of this infection, ketoacidosis, or an allergic reaction, and don't take it if you're on dialysis. Taking Jardiance with the sulfonylurea or insulin may cause low blood sugar.
Man, I wish I was out there.
Let's unretire.
Why not?
Dan Marino?
You all right?
22.
Delay a game. Number 13.
I'm good right here, bro.
Should we?
Don't even think about it.
This is our chance. It resonates through generations, past and future. It drives champions, toe-to-toe and arm-in-arm. When our chance signals victory, it shakes the foundation. It is the foundation. Together, we climb its peaks and search its valleys. It fuels our ambitions. We wear it, fly it, raise it, claim it. This is our chant. What will you do when this is your chant?
$273. This is how much you spend every month on subscriptions.
I only have like two or three, right?
That's what we all think. But in reality, we have so much more that we don't even know we're paying for.
So how do I put more of this cash back in my pocket?
Rocket Money is a financial app that tells you every subscription you're paying for, even that one you forgot about from 5 years ago.
Huh, I can't believe I'm still paying for this. I'll call and cancel right now.
Wait. With Rocket Money, they even cancel it for you.
Really?
All you have to do is tap a few buttons and they'll take care of it. Download Rocket Money today.
Why pay over $100 a month for cable when it's half the cost for Fubo TV? Get all the channels you want on the only live TV streaming service rated number one in customer satisfaction by J.D. Power. Try free at FuboTV.com.
You're really making all of this by hand.
Oh, yeah. The avocados are hand-mashed, the chips are hand-tossed, and everything is made fresh.
You make it fresh every day?
Yes, every day. The Chipotle way is we make it fresh every day.
Sounds delicious.
You're watching the Sling TV Halftime Report. This game is the biggest of the year.
This is going to be a hell of a game tonight. I can't wait.
Did Just the start of a fantastic football Saturday, week two of the college football season. Dan Mullen, Sam Acho, Matt Berry back with you. Look, when you have this game a year ago, one-point game, 15 penalties for Alabama, sloppy. They got out with a win. This time around, they're trotting out a quarterback in Jalen Milroe we have not seen in the Nick Saban era.
Yeah, very different offense. Tommy Reese, new coordinator coming in. And Nick Saban going back to kind of early Alabama days where they were going to be a power running team. And Jalen Milroe is the guy. And they're doing it differently, not a power eye formation, with a running quarterback. And his ability to beat you with his legs, whether it's a designed run or his ability to extend plays like we're seeing tonight with Jalen Daniels and beat you as the play breaks down, he makes it happen with his legs. But when that happens, as you're seeing, his ability keeps his eyes down the field. He's got great targets. You see him going deep on play action to Isaiah Bond right there. He has playmakers on the outside. The ability to run the ball simplifies the defense, which opens up the pass game.
But that pass game can be negated if you have a defender like Jalen Ford who can take the ball away. Last year, he accumulated 9 turnovers, 4 interceptions, 3 forced fumbles, 2 fumble recoveries, and he was doing it this year as well. This is last year's game. That's Jalen Ford, number 41, with the sack. You see interceptions in the end zone. That's all last year. But even this year, he's already had an interception against Rice. And so if you're following those big guys up front, guys like T'Vondre Sweat, 6'4", 362, guys like Byron Murphy on the freaks list, if you have those guys in front of you, it gives you freedom to roam and then get more possessions for your quarterback, Quinn Ewers.
Did you know that is the 4th different Jalen that we've mentioned in this halftime report?
I actually think I knew that because of the commercial break you...
That is not research approved. Matt Stack, right at you. Hey, look, for Texas to get this win tomorrow, 57-game non-conference winning streak for the Tide.
Going all the way back to Nick Saban's first year losing to Louisiana Monroe. That post game must have motivated a lot of people. There must be stories about that one.
Yeah, 15 years in counting must have motivated people. Hey, there are so many topics. Who's on upset alert? What two team needs to be confident? And what do you think of Acho's blazer? We're mulling it over next.
With Sling TV bringing you the best price for college football on ESPN, you can take your love of the game to the next level, like these guys. The college football you love, the live TV you love.
I told myself I was okay with my moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis symptoms.
With my psoriatic arthritis symptoms. But just okay isn't okay.
And I was done settling.
If you still have symptoms after a TNF blocker like Humira or Enbrel, Rinvoq is different and may help. Rinvoq is a once-daily pill that can dramatically relieve RA and PSA symptoms, including fatigue for some. It can stop joint damage, and in PSA, can leave skin clear or almost clear.
Rinvoq can lower your ability to fight infections, including TB, serious infections and blood clots, some fatal, cancers including lymphoma and skin cancer, death, heart attack, stroke, and tears in the stomach or intestines occurred. People 50 and older with at least one heart disease risk factor have higher risks. Don't take if allergic to Rinvoq, as serious reactions can occur. Tell your doctor if you are or may become pregnant.
Done settling?
Ask your rheumatologist for Rinvoq.
And take back what's yours.
Learn how AbbVie could help you save.
This wasn't no bear. It was like a bear squatch.
Dad, what's a bear squatch?
It's a cross between a bear and a sas. It's made up. He's usually sleeping.
He'll never sleep again.
Patrick, Jake from State Farm. Explain this bundling thing again.
All right, Coach Reed. Let's say these fries are your car, right? And
And this burger is your home.
Okay.
It can be more affordable if you bundle them together.
Kind of like a combo meal.
I'm like a combo meal.
Explain it again with those nuggies.
Bundling. Just another way to save with the personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Whoa.
Yeah, he always goes big.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
Wow, thorough. Does he know the party's not till next week?
Ah, Reese's. They'll get you. They will get you good.
We started at 12, went an 11 deep.
Let's go.
And dropping dimes since 9-6. What happened when the Big 8 met the Southwest? seven Heismans. Count them. We're six at the net, five on the floor, and four schools stronger. We put up threes, throw up deuces, and make one thing clear. We've always been greater than 12.
This halftime report is presented by Sling TV, the college football you love, the live TV you love.
Oh, week two of the college football season. We are ready. Are you? There's so many topics to touch on. I was texting Coach Mullen this week. I said, Coach, what do you want to talk about on Friday? He said, Matt, I'm mulling it over. I'll get back to you. And I said, well, you got to come up with a topic soon. So here's what we came up with. We are mulling it over. Which team needs to be careful of a letdown after such a big win in week one, Colorado or Florida State?
This is a tough one, but I'm going to go with Colorado, right? Because everyone now believes going into week one, it was only Colorado that believed. Now everyone believes. Sam believes, you believe, everybody believes. And now they're being told how great they are. They went from having a chip on their shoulder, we're going to shock the world, to now being patted on the back. As we know, in the game of football, it's a game of inches. There's only 6 inches between a pat on the back and a kick in the rear end. And they got to be careful with a very physical Nebraska team coming in. And their one weakness last week was the run defense.
Let's check that out. By the way, Nebraska comes in after blowing a late game. They feel bad about themselves. Colorado feels good about themselves. Collision of styles going into week two. All right, we are mulling it over. Which team needs to be more cautious about a disappointing season after week one? Who needs to be more worried, Clemson or Florida?
Definitely Clemson, because you look in that game, I thought Cade Klubnik took a step backwards. He regressed from what we saw the year before. They were out-athleted by Duke. Where are you seeing these perimeter players that are unbelievable for Clemson, that can score at will with the ball in their hands? They didn't look as athletic, and they came into the season with championship aspirations. Mm-hmm. They've lost three out of their last four games, and I think they got to be careful with how this season turns for them moving forward.
By the way, this is a coach who knows how to watch talent and film. I'm going to repeat that sentence again. They were out-athleted by Duke. A sentence you never thought you'd say in this game. Clemson is going to be worth watching for the rest of the season. And finally, we are mulling it over. Which ranked team goes on the road and needs to be careful of an upset alert?
And the great thing, you look at all these ranked teams on the road, usually means we have a great weekend of college football ahead of us. I'm going to go with two. I'm going to start with the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. NC State, week one, came up here to Storrs, Connecticut. Tough game, a little bit sloppy. Dave Doran's going to get this team right. Peyton Wilson, the linebacker. Yeah. Aiden White, the ball-hawking DB. Notre Dame's got to go into Carter-Finley Stadium. Not an easy place to go play. Dave Doran's going to have that NC State team ready. The second one, Wisconsin's got to be careful. Washington State beat them last year in Madison. They're heading out to Pullman. Wazoo's got a player, Cam Ward, who might be the most exciting player that nobody's really ever heard of. Had four touchdowns passing last week, one rushing. He is a dynamic guy, and I think Washington better be careful.
You go on the Palouse, it's a tough place to play. And by the way, Washington State, along with Oregon State, they are playing scorned this year, being left behind by the Pac-12. It is a great college football weekend. Sit tight, just wait, mulling it over for the rest of Saturday. The SportsCenter Show Pod is mulling it over when they should be ready to relieve us. And when they do, they'll be talking about championship weekend, plus Alcaraz up 2-0 over on ESPN. All right, so back to the second half, just a moment. You walked into work today, and I was like, wait a second. And then you're like, Matt, this isn't even the best part.
That wasn't what I said.
Give America what you want. I mean, look at this.
Hey, no. I like it, Coach. I like it. Hey, man, I'm just trying to rep the Big 12. You know, hopefully, you know,
rep the Big 12.
And the SEC until next year, right? Sure. Big 12, SEC, right? Conglomerate. ESPN.
I don't know how to break this to you. You were repping one thing there. there was no doubt about it. Rock chalk beatdown. Does Illinois have it to come back?
Domino's delivery? is coming in hot.
Oh, is this my turn?
Because now you can get pizza dropped to a location near you with new Domino's Pinpoint Delivery. Just drop a pin on the Domino's app and get two medium, two-topping pizzas for $6.99 each delivered just about anywhere. It's Domino's Pinpoint Delivery.
We have a special guest today on ESPN College Game Day, the Geico Deco.
Just get to the part when you tell everyone how easy it is to insure what's important to them. Home, car, even RV. Come on, there's an RV right there. Did he even see the talking points I gave him?
I don't believe so, sir.
For all your insurance needs, from home to car to RV, it's easy to Geico.
Desmond?
I forgot the talking points.
Man, I wish I was out there.
Let's unretire.
That's why I'm at.
Hey, Grandpa!
Grandpa?
I still got it!
Hey, I need that senior discount.
I'm good right here, bro.
Unretirement? Who'd be dumb enough to do that?
This is not the first all-electric car. That's because no BMW sees the road until it's reached the ultimate standard, our own. A standard that demands that every BMW drives and feels exactly like a BMW should. Unparalleled performance and precision handling made possible by electric engineering. But isn't that what you'd expect from the ultimate electric driving machine? Build your own all-electric BMW i5 today.
We started at 12. Running 11 deep, and dropping dimes since 9-6. What happened when the Big 8 met the Southwest? 7 Heismans, count them. With 6 at the net, 5 on the floor, and 4 schools stronger. We put up threes, throw up deuces, and make one thing clear. We've always been greater than 12.
Last year, I got stuck paying for my ex's internet for months before I finally caught it. That won't happen this year, thanks to Rocket Money. Rocket Money finds hidden subscriptions, and you can cancel the ones you don't want with one tap. Join Rocket Money today.
This is FuboTV. It's a better way to watch live news, shows, and sports without cable. Watch multiple games at once with MultiView. Try free at FuboTV.com.
I'm Livy Dunn, All-American gymnast and Vuori athlete. When you travel and train as much as I do, you find happiness where you are. On the mat or on the sand, movement and comfort are essential. That's why I live in performance joggers by Vuori. Made from DreamKnit fabric that's made of 89% recycled materials. Effortlessly soft and made to move as much as I do. My happiness starts here, in the softest joggers on the planet.
28-7 Kansas on top of Illinois at the half. ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Ram Trucks. It is the Big 12 on ESPN. Rock, chalk. This team looks like they are for real. They started 5-0 last year, skidded down the stretch. Kansas off to a roaring start in week 2. And Ishraf Andre, where they are presenting so many pictures to Illinois, and there's nothing normal about it. It's as if it's one of those M.C. Escher paintings. Where do you look? How is it working? But it is.
Illinois talked to us about getting themselves lined up properly, but they're seeing so many different looks and motions and personnel groupings that it's confusing. And Kansas basically going where the Illini defense are not lined up.
7-for-8 on third down, almost 300 yards of total offense in the first half, and Kansas receives to begin the second half. This possession feels like it could be the ballgame.
Are only stopped or forced to punt one time in the first half.
Here is Trevor Wilson. And navigates a path across the 30. That's where Kansas will start. Down to Paul Carcaterra.
Well, Nish is caught up with Brett Bielema, Illinois head coach, and
Only 39 yards on the ground, but he actually thinks there's opportunity to run the ball early on. He said there was some success. They abandoned it too quickly. Defensively, not pleased with that unit at all. And he said the struggle was dealing with all of the different looks that Kansas presented out wide, right up the middle. So many different variety looks offensively, and stopping Jalen Daniels, it's that simple. He's best player on the field, hands down.
This guy's pretty good too. Devin Neal, first play, third quarter, finally tracked down from behind inside the 30. He picks up 43 on the run.
Thank goodness for Scott on the back end. Otherwise, Devin Neal is gone. I mean, what a cut in the hole. The entire, I think you might have thought could have run through that one. It was so big by the offensive line. But man, what a job up front. And then Devin Neal rewarding the work of his offensive line.
Seven carries, 86 yards, and a touchdown for Neal.
Hey, I think you got it. I got trust in you.
Don't tie my shoes sometimes. Neal picks up about a yard and a half. Jason Bean was in the game.
Maybe I ought to put the ball in Clark's hands.
Yeah,
then.
Better call.
Well, this, you talk about hot knife through butter to start the second half. That's what this Jayhawk offense has been all night long, pretty much. But the offensive line, a very experienced group up front, doing the job here tonight.
Four starters return on the offensive line. Kansas returned at 91% of its offensive production from a year ago, most in college football. Daniels to the air, flushed, throws it away.
That's smart.
Tariq Barnes in pursuit.
Wasn't going to outrun the defense, and you live to fight again here on third down. Throw it away, come back on third down. That's just the maturity of Jalen Daniels and him having the experience under center.
Daniels tonight, 14 out of 20 passing, 189 yards through the air, two passing touchdowns. He's also run for 33 yards. He didn't play last week, did warm up.
I can't tell.
Had some back tightness in the preseason. Grimm's been a big third down guy. He's in motion. Daniels throws his way, and Grimm can't hold on. Good coverage by Xavier Scott. It's fourth down, and let's see what Kansas elects to do. They will bring on the kick team for a field goal try.
Very comfortable with Seth Keller from about 48 yards at end. So this is going to be about 41 or so on this attempt.
A grad transfer from Texas State. This is a Kansas team. They had some struggles on special teams a year ago. And the field goal try is good. A flag at the tail end of the play.
Won't be a penalty that gives Kansas an automatic first down here.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 88, Illinois. This is his first foul that leads towards disqualification. That foul will be enforced on the kickoff.
It was after the kick. So that's, therefore, it's going to happen after the kickoff. Thank goodness for Brett Bielema and his bunch. It didn't happen during, where it gives Kansas an automatic first down.
Last week in the first half against Toledo, penalties a problem. They had 9 first half penalties last week. Only committed 1 in the second half when they came back.
I mean, you just got to call it like it is. This is a good football team.
It is.
Kansas is a good, solid, top to bottom on both sides of the ball, good. And they've got depth, not afraid to play, younger players. They're gonna be a tough out for many, many programs on most weekends this fall.
A lot of these players who stuck with the program, now they took their lumps early in the career. That was baptism by fire, and it is now turned into maturity and experience.
He tells us they were one of the few programs in the country or had the least amount of transfers, guys leaving this Kansas program. They stay here, they love the coach, love playing for Lance Leipold.
With the kickoff from midfield after the penalty, no chance for a return, and urgency has already set in for Illinois. Down 31-7, 13-14 to go in this third quarter. Can Luke Altmyer channel a little second half magic for the second week in a row?
I think he's going to have to. Otherwise, you run into becoming one-dimensional as you try to get yourself back in this game. And then that opens up the pass rush of Kansas. And they've proven early in the game, especially in the first quarter, that they can get home.
Meyer gives it to McCray. He gets the edge and is thrown down. Flag at the end of the play. A little commotion on that Illinois sideline.
Extracurricular going on over there. Let's see who it actually is called on.
J.B. Brown.
Dotson mixing it up over there.
He was the player who brought McCray to the ground.
I didn't see it with the initial tackle, that it was a late hitter.
After the play, of course, the light conduct, defense number one. This is his first foul that leads towards disqualification. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Kenny Logan, the all-conference safety. First penalty of the game against Kansas.
Saying it wasn't him.
Now we're being told our replay cameras didn't see anything that would constitute unsportsmanlike.
I don't know, certainly not on Kenny Logan Jr.
So Illinois now in Kansas territory, empty set. Altmyer trying back time. Crunched.
Whoa.
Austin Booker, the Minnesota transfer, with a sack.
My goodness. Altmyer steps up in the pocket, but he did not see Booker coming from that side. That's about as good a form tackle as you're going to get in this day and age of football.
Sack by Kansas on the ground. A lot of spinning. And a couple of yards for McCray, the sophomore from Enterprise, Alabama, that sits right above the Florida Panhandle.
He had his best game as an Illinois player a couple of years ago against Purdue, where he rushed for 156 yards. That's his career high.
Pressure off the edge. That one juggled and caught by Casey Washington.
You have to think about going for it here.
I think you got to go for it, Andre.
And he was closer to the first down marker, but he bobbled it, Anish, and that took it back once the defender got there. So they're looking for forward progress somewhere around the 40, but it's going to be back around about the 43-yard line or so. So fourth down and about four here for the Illini. I would move Altmyer around. They opened the game last week against Toledo with a bootleg where he hit Ryman in the flat. I don't see Ryman in the game, but certainly he could go to another receiver with that look.
Illinois, the first of the half.
Oh, hey.
What are you doing out here?
Letting people know Corona Premier is a light beer.
Oh, it is a light beer.
90 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs.
If only there was a way to tell people.
Whoa.
Corona Premier, unexpectedly, light beer.
When football was introduced, Arby's and boneless wings weren't a thing.
Now they are a thing. And eating $5 boneless wings with fries is the most popular sport in America. Arby's, we have the meat.
This ring symbolizes the eternity of our relationship.
We met in seventh grade typing class. 16 years later, I said, will you be my girl?
Jesse, I've always been your girl.
The Chosen Collection, only at Jared. Love brilliantly.
Tourists. Tourists that turn into scientists. Tourists taking photos that are analyzed by AI. So researchers can help life underwater flourish.
Let's unretire. Why not?
Do it again.
I'm good right here.
Businesses need 5G solutions today. That's why they choose T-Mobile for Business. MLB partners with T-Mobile to not only enhance the fan experience, but to advance how the game is played. AAA relies on T-Mobile's network to stay connected nationwide so they can help get their members back on the road. And we're helping Pano AI innovate to stop the spread of wildfires. Now's the time to see what America's largest 5G network can do for your business.
KFC Chicken Nuggets?
Chicken Nuggets!
KFC Chicken Nuggets!
Chicken nuggets?
It's dinner time. Get KFC Original Recipe Chicken Nuggets. 10 pieces for just $5.
You know why I love Halloween?
Why?
People give me Kit Kats for free.
Son, you're 8. All your Kit Kats are free.
Happy Halloween. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat.
You inspire the Lexus ES to be, well, more you. So thank you. We hope you like your work.
Israel Adesanya is the best middleweight on planet Earth. I say so. Strickland!
I want the title. Let's do this.
Last week against Toledo, Illinois down one late. 4th and 4. Luke Altmyer standing in, takes the hit. Great throw, great catch. Casey Washington, and extends the drive. Illinois would kick the game-winning field goal. 4th and 4 again, this time down 24, but another spot where this feels like it might be the ball game.
The UNS foul, which was like fouls on number 3, not number 1, from Kansas.
Yeah, that's what we thought. Yeah, Kenny Logan Jr., who's one of the leaders of this entire team. He's like, it was not me.
It's on Melo Dotson instead. Isaiah Williams, the motion man. Kansas bringing pressure. Altmyer underneath. That's going to be short. It's Bryant the catch. Turnover on downs. Kansas ball. Andre, that's to a receiver who's not close.
Yeah, and you've got to run this route, especially on fourth down. The depth of the marker, so that when you're tackled or past the marker, when you're tackled, he should be going upfield right now. When you're tackled, you already have the first down. He runs the route short of the first down marker, gets tackled immediately. Kansas gets themselves off the field with the football here. Just got to have the headspace of knowing exactly where to get to, so when you're tackled, you already have the first down.
Kansas with the football. They have scored on all but one of their possessions as we check in with Kark.
Anish, I'm with Travis Goff, athletic director at Kansas. Pretty cool, packed house here. I have to ask you, you were hired in 2021, and your first order of business was to get a football coach, and you went after Lance Leipold. Why?
Proven program builder. What he had done at Whitewater, Division III, but hey, it's all the same, right? Build programs with that kind of sustained success. Goes off to Buffalo. Great place, but a tough place to build football, and had those kinds of years and the way he built it. It was proven. He had a plan, and ultimately this fit thing matters, and we really felt like he fit KU.
He also can be pretty creative offensively. I'll tell you that much. That was a sweet play. What excites you the most about this program?
Well, I think at the end of the day, we're only 2 years into this build. We've lifted, obviously, the floor. We've solidified the foundation. So in a lot of ways, we're just getting started. You see and feel the energy from the fan base responding. And I really think we're changing a culture around football at the University of Kansas, and we're really getting a taste of what that could be like here.
What can you tell me about the Gateway District project?
Well, I think we got a chance to create one of the most intimate environments. No bad seats in the building. One of the great home field advantages, great fan experiences. One of the other cool aspects is we're changing this football ops building over here too. So now the experience for our young men every day will stack up with anything in the country.
We know about Kansas basketball. We're learning about Kansas football. Amazing job by you, Coach Leipold, and his staff. Thank you so much, Travis.
Thank you, buddy. Appreciate you guys.
Awesome. Awesome what they're building here in Lawrence, Kansas.
And the AD isn't alone. There is a deep-rooted care or deep-rooted interest in getting this athletic program up to speed, not just in basketball, but in football. That ball comes out at the end, and it's picked up by Clayton Bush, the safety. Illinois gets it back with Kansas on the verge of the red zone. The Illini needed that. 8:42 to go, third quarter. Jayhawks in full control despite the turnover.
A truck is a tool, but a Ram is life. It's the Let's Load Up the ATVs life. The My Kids Play Way Too Many Sports life. The Let's Find a Secret Spot to Fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 4,000 retail consumer cash allowance on most 2023 Ram 1500 trucks. See your Ram dealer today.
It's Reese's season.
Boo.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Picking up the Duralast brakes I ordered online this morning.
Right now, you can save 15% when you buy a set of Duralast pads with rotors.
Hey, Coach, I brought Tostitos.
Why is Micah Parsons here?
Whoa.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
We make a great team.
Liberty Mutual customized my car insurance, and I saved hundreds. With the money I saved, I started a dog walking business. Oh! Oh no, it's just a bunny! Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
When your child starts getting into everything, you may need a little help. So Duracell created the only lithium coin batteries with a bitter coating to help discourage swallowing.
Subway is now slicing their deli meats fresh. That's why they're preferred by this pro who won the Super Bowl twice.
And this pro with a perfect slice.
And if we prefer it, we know America will too.
What about the Spaniards?
And I guess Spain.
My store, my design business,
we're exploding. But my old internet was not letting me run the show.
So we switched to Verizon Business Internet.
They have business-grade internet nationwide.
Make the switch. It's your business. It's your Verizon.
Number 8 has special meaning for Quentin Lasseter. His father, Kwame, passed away in 2019 and wore the number at Kansas, playing defensive back. Kwame also played in the NFL for 10 years. His brother, Kwame Jr., played wide receiver at Kansas and wore the number as well, currently playing for the Cincinnati Bengals. And he was at last week's game on the sideline when Quentin made a huge INT, a special moment indeed. And Quentin told me some of the best advice his dad gave him: practice like you're going to get cut from the team. And Quentin has that compete level. Andre, I know you love that.
Love it, love it. Working hard every single day.
Altmyer finding Isaiah Williams, who turns that screen into a first down. And Andre, you saw the final moments of that interception last week from Lassiter, handing the ball right to his big brother.
Yeah, that's sweet. It's a family of just guys that have played the sport. They respect one another, grew up together playing the game. It's always rewarding when you see that.
Kansas rushes four. There's Williams, unable to bring that one in. It would have been his fourth catch.
That was Williams and Washington that Barry Looney told us that he wanted to get the ball in their hands a little bit more. Their playmakers in this offense need to touch it a little bit more.
One of the biggest surprises tonight has been the way Kansas's defense has played.
We knew they had a chance to be special on the offensive side with 91%, as you mentioned. Well, that production returning for 2023, had no idea this defense could be this special.
Here is Reggie Love, cutback lane, and it sets up a third down for Illinois. Andre, you're in minus territory given the score. Is this four down territory?
I think so, and I think you run the football here to get either pick it up on third down, or you get close enough to where you're going to go for it on fourth down in about a yard or so. So I would certainly be thinking that way with Reggie Love.
Lyman, the tight end, motions. They'll hand it off. Love to the outside. And a first down into Kansas territory. A pickup of 11 by Love.
Excellent job by the offensive line of the Illini. They're just going to take it and go east and west and look for any avenue in which to turn up. And Reggie Love does exactly that, picks up the first down and keeps this drive alive for Illinois.
The fake to McCray. Altmaier on the run. And I think that might have been picked. It was. Kansas took it away. Melo Dotson.
That ball just kept bouncing around in East and then all of a sudden found its way into the hands of Melo Dotson. But hey, you want to drop that flag on me? Well, an unsportsmanlike contact penalty. I'm going to make up for it, coach. I got you. And the ball just finds its way right into the hands of number three.
Pat Bryant was trying to bring it in. He had two touchdown catches last week. Could not quite finish it. And Dotson snags it for an interception.
This is field position. Anish, where a sudden change, I'm going up top. I am taking a shot right here.
And that might be Skinner, number zero.
They've got the coverage that they want. Man-to-man across the board. Just hold the safety in the middle of the field.
Instead, they'll run. And Devin Neal continues to put up big numbers. Give him 17 more. He's north of 100 yards rushing on the evening.
What a play. A little direct snap and just getting him outside. Boy, he has had some game tonight. This offense has been very, very impressive.
Now they've got 3-4 running backs they really like. Dylan McDuffie's in there now. McDuffie, 2 years ago, was a 1,000-yard rusher at Buffalo.
And to your point, Lachlan's already caught a touchdown pass in this thing.
Off play action, Daniels lets it fly. It's caught. A red zone chance coming for Kansas. Lawrence Arnold with another reception, his fifth of the night.
The timing in which Daniels is delivering the football doesn't give the secondary of Illinois a chance to knock him down, intercept it, anything. It's the timing that's making the difference. The ball's out of his hands before the receiver has even come out of his brain. Boy, that's impressive.
Look at the numbers for Daniels. Casey joins him in the backfield. They'll option it. This is McDuffie. And tackled by Newton, second down.
I think the offensive line of Kansas, we haven't given enough credit. Providing the protection. We talked a little bit about Devin Neal. He can't do it by himself. Holes are just opening up for him.
Well, Daniels will try to do this himself, and he got maybe a yard or two. Scott, Miles Scott with the tackle, third down.
Kansas, we talk about this big offensive line. They entered tonight's game with 206 combined starts along the offensive line. That's a lot of experience. And in order for that group to be effective, they have to play together. It's like hands in a glove. You know, five fingers in a glove. That's exactly what you think of with the offensive line. One guy playing off another guy's blocks. The continuity up front, just as important.
Daniels checks down, catch made, Million. Touchdown, Jayhawks. Flag down at the 7-yard line.
Wow. What an effort by Million to get himself into the end zone, though. Just refusing to go down.
During the run, the legal block in the back. Offense, number 89. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. It will be third down. Since we had a touchdown, the clock will start at the snap.
Mason Fairchild, the tight end.
Millions telling, come on, big fella. He's right there, in the, right in the middle of the screen. A little bit of block in the back. I don't know about that one. He just as easily have kept the flag in his hand, in his pocket. Talking about this offensive line, and he's Mike Nowitzki hadn't allowed a sack coming into this game in 846 snaps. He is the leader up front, fifth-year starter. If you can,
and not a fifth-year senior, fifth-year starter.
If he can stay healthy, started for Coach Leipold at Buffalo and transferred here with him.
Here comes McDuffie, right side. And running out of real estate, fourth down. The Kansas coaching staff was telling us that Nowitzki took over for a four-year starter at Buffalo. So this coaching staff,
seven straight years.
No, nine eight straight years.
That's right, four, nine straight
years. 5-4 is nine.
That's exactly right. He will graduate. 30 left tackle Hooney will graduate. Everybody else is returning, so you're going to have about just about the same production next year coming back for Kansas.
30-yard field goal try by Keller is good. Three more for Kansas. 34-7 in front of 40,000 plus at Memorial.
Rockies, Giants, an NL West battle on Sunday Night Baseball.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Hi, my check engine light's on.
Let's see what our free fix finder service says. And if you need help, we can refer you to a shop.
That's an easy fix.
Get in the zone, AutoZone.
Cheez-It snapped.
How's it taste?
It's so thin, crispy, and cheesy. And I just want to keep eating it. And eating it.
They love them.
Snapped. So good, we may run out of cheese.
At Domino's, there's an endless debate. Does adding pepperoni to something always make it better? Yeah. Debate over. Introducing Domino's new pepperoni stuffed cheesy bread. Loaded up with irresistible pepperoni, it's our most delicious stuffed cheesy bread yet. Only at Domino's.
Can't sleep?
Nope.
I can't sleep either.
It only gets tougher with age.
Well, maybe you'll sleep better knowing that Progressive protects your home, auto, and business.
Wait, is this all a dream?
Seems real to me.
Nothing out of the ordinary here.
The fact that this Reese's ad showed up at this exact moment proves that your devices are listening to your stomach.
KFC's $20 fill-up box.
Alexa, play Kentucky Fried Chicken Night.
Oh, yes, it's chicken night. Kentucky Fried Chicken Night. Oh, yes, it's chicken night.
Make it a chicken night with KFC's $20 fill-up box.
Baby, it's over.
I mean, we both saw this coming.
I'm sorry.
The way you see it is said to depend on where you sit. At X-Chair, we think it also gets down to how you sit, which is why our technology is light years ahead. X-Chair has done it again with our groundbreaking LMX technology, providing hours of infinite comfort no matter where in the world you're sitting. By synthesizing the universe's elements, bringing hot, cold, and touch into one extraordinary seating experience, our mission is to help you discover that every workday can happen with body and mind in an out-of-this-world place of comfort and productivity. X-Chair is charting a new course, helping workers everywhere find comfort as their work worlds zoom back and forth. Even though your work reality may continue to shift, we've got our eye on the future of work so you can focus on the present. And from where we sit, the future still feels good. Save up to $300 and revamp your workspace during X-Chair's Labor Day sale. Ends September 12th.
Marriott Waterfront.
34-7, Kansas. On top of Illinois, 3:46 to go, third quarter. The Jayhawks eyeing a 2-0 start. And they follow this game up with a road one at Nevada. Then they play BYU before visiting Texas.
Yeah, I got to believe they're going to be favored in every game going into that Texas game in Austin.
I'm not sure there are any games, Andre, on their schedule where they're not going to have a shot, which was not the case just a few years ago.
Yeah.
The kick is a touchback, and now a quick word from Verbo.
A place to reunite with your actual family of five and your chosen family of 105,213. Verbo. Football away, baby.
Illinois got the football. Josh McCray, the running back. The Illini so far, 172 yards of total offense. It just has not gone right. Altmaier able to complete, broken tackle, and a pickup of 7 by Hank Beatty.
Get started. That's a good drive starter for this possession. Figure out how to live at second and medium, second and short.
Back to the air, back to Beatty. And a first down for Illinois. Beatty, a sophomore from Rochester, Illinois. Former Gatorade Player of the Year in the state. Third generation Illini.
Nowhere to go for McCray. And he just bottled up as soon as he got in the backfield. And before that last first down, Kansas had doubled up Illinois in terms of first downs for the game. It's 22-11. And he just moved to 12 with that last first down. That's amazing.
We'll receive a look here on second and long. And Altmaier goes down. Fourth sack by this Kansas defense into the second of the night by Austin Booker.
He is a pass rush specialist. They love him. The transfer, as you mentioned, from Minnesota. Long and powerful. It's what the coaching staff told us. And looked as though Julian Pearl could not hold him off. Luke Altmaier. It's been a long night offensively for Illinois. The only success they had was right before the half when they chose to go no huddle. I think this is the ideal time. But they've got to break from the game plan and start going some no huddle.
Altmaier lots of green grass. He's got the first down and much more. Nobody in front. Can they catch him? Luke Altmyer, touchdown. 72 yards. Open sesame for the Ole Miss transfer.
Caught him in man-to-man. Receivers are running down the field. He breaks out the backside, and no one's there. I actually thought he was going to get caught because he was looking back, kind of cruising. Almost like he could not believe he had that much room.
Well, we couldn't either.
Illinois will go two.
It's the man-to-man, and everybody's crossing away from where he breaks out of the pocket. So there's no one there. Guys have got to come from the other side of the field, and they can't find it, can't get there. Go for two here.
Altmyer trying to find an open receiver. Nobody there. Good coverage on the back end by Kansas.
He took a shot from Booker. He is still on the turf. He took a shot. I don't know if he just got the wind knocked out of him or what, but man, what a shot from Austin Booker.
Brett Bielema not happy. No flag on the play.
He wants. Oof. I mean, that's shoulder pads to the rib area. He comes at it actually with a running start. It's a legal tackle.
The previous play is under review for a targeting foul.
Now the question is, did it lead with the crown of the helmet?
Yeah, I thought I saw the left shoulder go into the midsection of Luke Altmyer. It looked legal to me. See what the replay officials think.
Couple of things to remember. In that case, Altmyer is a defenseless player. A quarterback in the act of throwing the ball.
It looks like he turns his head at the last second to avoid what would be a targeting foul if he leads, as you said, with the crown of his helmet.
But if you lead with the crown of the helmet, defenseless or not, it doesn't matter. And I think, you know, in this case, you know, it looks like he did turn his head a little. Call on the field was no foul. The replay booth initiated the review. And remember, when it comes to targeting, you have to confirm targeting upstairs. If there's any doubt, it will not be called.
Just enough of a head turn to avoid the targeting penalty, but we'll see.
After review, personal foul, targeting with the crown of the helmet, number 9. Number 9 is disqualified for the remainder of the game. It will be a half the distance goal, retry.
And now Lance Leipold, not happy. Austin Booker, 2 sacks tonight, has been disqualified. And because this is a second half targeting foul, he'll now miss the first half of the next game against Nevada.
I thought the head turned enough where the left part of the helmet is in the rib area and it's not the crown. Looks like the head's to the side. As you said, if there's any doubt, the call on the field would stand.
Number 9 must come out for one play.
I thought that's what would happen. I thought the call on the field would stand.
So not decisive enough for you?
Not nearly decisive enough.
It gives Illinois a second chance at this two-point conversion, and a new quarterback comes in. It's the backup, John Paddock, grad transfer from Ball State. He will hand it off, and McCray pushing ahead, and he gets in for the two-point conversion. And they may look at this one as well.
I think they're going to have to take a look at it because that McCray's knee might have been down, and then he stretched the ball out. So we get,
where's the ball when he goes down?
Every scoring play is reviewed. So it's moving around.
Knees down there.
That the two-point conversion was good. But then the further review.
That's another one where I think the ruling on the field will stand, because you almost lose the ball and you're trying to draw a line as to where it is. It looks short to me.
And remember, when you see that goal line, if it crosses any part of that goal line when that knee is down, the conversion is good.
Does he lose the ball, lose possession? You have to piece this together from a couple of different looks. That look, and then the one from the side as the knee touches. Blend those together.
Well, it looks like when the knee touches, he's got the ball. And so at that
and
point,
short
ball.
And short of the goal line.
It just depends where they deem the spot is when that knee is down. And again, ball on the field, conversion good. It just has to cross the beginning of that white strip, the goal line.
Man, that looks short to me.
Question is definitively short.
If you're looking at the Jayhawk player who's on the ground, his helmet, that's the goal line, and his is barely touching. And the ball's short of his helmet at that point.
After a review, the ruling of a two-point conversion stands.
Well, in case you're wondering,
0 for 2 tonight.
34-15. Kansas still in control of the game. For some folks watching, there is still an element or two of drama. Not over yet. 1:35 to go, third quarter. Wilson only brings this out to the 15-yard line. Saturday night, 7 o'clock, ESPN. Number 10, Texas goes to Alabama. This will be a conference game next year. For now, Big 12, SEC. Steve Sarkisian heading back to Tuscaloosa. Game day, 9 a.m. Eastern. You got the Pat McAfee broadcast on ESPN2. Xavier Worthy, Kool-Aid, McKinstry. You got a pretty good receiver matchup there, too.
It's going to be a heck of a game.
Here comes Highshaw.
What Kansas. A nice edge block by Cabledew, the right tackle, to secure the edge for Highshaw. And I mean, just cleared it out. Put a guy on the edge defender on the ground, and that just cleared things up for Highshaw to turn the corner. What a heck of a block.
28 yards on the play. Kansas has now run for more than 200 on the ground.
And Cabledew, a three-year starter who has really, really improved. Started 27 straight games coming into today, or 29 now with the start tonight.
Direct snap, Highshaw. Picks up three.
Well, you got to be on alert for anything if you're Illinois. Now they're direct snapping to Highshaw with Daniels coming across as the play fake, and they have not given it to Daniels, but I could easily see a handoff to Daniels and then him stopping and throwing that bait.
Kansas tonight, 16 plays of 10 or more yards. They've put up 430 yards of total offense together in the first three quarters. Three in the books in
this
Lawrence. Jayhawk
in the third quarter.
Look to be the real deal. Up 34-15.
You know when a melty grilled cheese sounds so good, but so does a bacony burger with creamy peppercorn ranch. And you couldn't possibly choose, cause brain no work too good when tummy empty. Sonic Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheese Burger Deal for $3.99.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels.
They've been told how you feel yourself doesn't matter. Then just like that, they're gone. Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade.
Rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
If you have heart disease and are on a statin, lowering cholesterol can be hard. Diets and exercise add to the struggle. Today, it's possible to go from struggle to cholesterol success with Leqvio. With a statin, Leqvio is proven to lower bad cholesterol by over 50% and keep it low with 2 doses a year. Common side effects were injection site reaction, joint pain, urinary tract infection, diarrhea, chest cold, pain in legs or arms, and shortness of breath. Ask your doctor about twice yearly Leqvio. Lower, longer Leqvio.
Goldfish, can I get a handful?
Sure.
Happy?
Go for the handful.
There's some things that go better together, like your workplace benefits and retirement savings. With Voya, considering all your financial choices together can help you be better prepared for unexpected events.
Voya, well planned, well invested, well protected.
Popeye's new sweet and spicy wings don't make sense. Marinated and tossed in a blend of chili, garlic, and ginger, as sweet as they are spicy.
Nice catch, Butterfingers.
Just like my Nana. We don't make sense. We make chicken.
Love that chicken from Popeye's.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Hi, my check engine light's on.
Let's see what our free fix finder service says. And if you need help, we can refer you to a shop.
That's an easy fix.
Get in the zone, AutoZone.
Here's some straight talk for you. Use your loved ones to save money on wireless. You could add your favorite son.
You could add your ex. Add grandma, but don't tell her about the unlimited talk part.
More lines mean more savings with Straight Talk. Get unlimited data, talk, and text for $25 a line.
I'll be there in 30 minutes, I think.
See you there.
I'm moving.
Please.
Oh, thank you.
Rerouting.
Class-leading safety and tech features to elevate your commute. The all-new Hyundai Kona.
Ah, Reese's. They'll get you. They will get you good.
Back in Lawrence, Kansas with Coach Lance Leipold. Coach, a running game is a team's best friend in a fourth quarter. 208 yards on the ground. Why has that run game been so effective tonight?
Well, again, I like we talked about at halftime, I think we've been able to mix it up pretty well and get some inside-outside runs as well as the play-action pass. And it's going to be very important here because momentum's kind of shifted with some calls and stuff. We're going to be able to keep that ground game going.
What concerns you about their offense?
Well, again, they're getting a little rhythm and hitting some. They got some guys that can make you miss. You know, I thought we had some, started to get a little bit of pressure. But, you know, again, anyone could strike in this game pretty quickly.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
To the air on the first play of the fourth quarter. And in Illinois territory, Trevor Wilson. Flag down. Sure of who this is actually on. It's been a while to talk about it.
Personal foul with targeting defense number 8. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down. The targeting aspect is under further review.
Yeah, that's a big one for Illinois. Tariq Barnes
three-year starter, captain, and quarterback of that linebacking group.
Yeah, he is the play caller. And if he doesn't indeed lead the game, then that's going to be a big, big loss.
Correction. There's only a foul for targeting. That play is under further review.
It's actually
they're looking at three.
Taz Nichols.
Nicholson.
Yeah, and not Tariq Barnes.
Now, Nicholson's their top corner. He played opposite Devin Witherspoon last year. So you're looking for an indicator that is not a defenseless player. It looks like he leads with the shoulder.
But to the head and neck area.
Yeah. But again, not a defenseless player. That is a ball carrier.
After review, there's no foul for targeting. Number three may remain in the game.
Yeah, that's the right call. When the player is not defenseless, in that case, unless it is the crown of the helmet, it's not going to be targeting. So Taz Nicholson can stay in. Yeah, they feel he's got a high ceiling, might be the next player out of that secondary to hear his name called by Roger Goodell. They had three of those a season ago. Devin Witherspoon in round one, Quan Martin in round two, Sidney Brown in round three. Although Goodell just does round one.
That's right. That takes a while. Round one takes a minute.
RPO, quick slant, big gainer. Down to the 30-yard line, Quentin Skinner. Former walk-on, put on scholarship a season ago.
Well, this offense can hit you fast, can hit you in a lot of different ways. And then you got a quarterback who's operating at a very, very high level. And it's extremely accurate.
Clayton Bush down on one knee for Illinois. And Andre for Skinner. Last year, he was used primarily as a deep threat. That's still his best skill. It's speed. It's going vertical. He's worked in the offseason to be better underneath, become a better route runner.
It's showing up. 75%. Is what Jalen Daniels is tonight. 21 of 28, 277, and two touchdown passes. And he's been magical on the ground as well. Nine carries, about 33 yards, just under 4 yards a carry.
You said it in the first half. There is just a calm and easiness to his game.
Just looks poised. You can tell that he has done it before. And nothing has surprised him that this Illini defense has done tonight.
Two tight ends in the game. Skinner now motions. On the ground. Driven out of bounds. Ishaw. Daniels, a fourth-year junior, but this is a guy who started a college game against Oklahoma when he was 17 years old. He doesn't turn 21 until October.
He's special. Super talented young man. Really understands this offense and how to make it work. With all the window dressing, all the movement, the personnel groupings, it operates at another level from Jason Bean when Daniels is in the game. And Bean's pretty good.
Pocket collapsing. Into the end zone. Intercepted by Xavier Scott.
Just took it away from Trevor Wilson. Who had a hand on it. Excellent play by Scott on the back end. Of just fighting Trevor Wilson for the football. It gives the Illini the ball at the 20-yard line and a chance to cut into this lead.
Hope.
What's my definition of success?
You know why I love Halloween?
Why?
People give me Kit Kats for free.
Son, you're 8. All your Kit Kats are free.
Happy Halloween. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat. KFC Chicken Nuggets?
Chicken nuggets.
KFC chicken nuggets.
KFC chicken nuggets.
chicken nuggets?
It's dinner time. Get KFC Original Recipe Chicken Nuggets. 10 pieces for just $5.
This necklace is a new piece of my soul.
It is one of my love languages to gift.
I always knew I had a sister, and she did it. When we met, it was what I longed for my entire life.
Explore our Brilliant Moments collection. Jared, love brilliantly.
Pacifico is a crisp golden lager, brewed for those who know. It's what's behind a label that matters.
Whee! Where'd Arby's Buffalo Boneless Wings go?
Whee!
Hot Honey Barbecue too.
Whee!
Oh, there they are, with fries for $5. Arby's, we have the meat.
My store, my design business,
we're exploding. But my old internet was not letting me run the show.
So we switched to Verizon Business Internet. They have business-grade internet nationwide.
Make the switch. It's your business. It's your Verizon.
19-year-old sensation Coco Gauff has stormed into her first U.S. Open final, but Aryna Sabalenka is ready for a fight. The U.S. Open Women's Championship, tomorrow at 4 on ESPN and ESPN+.
Hey guys, this is Joe, founder of Vuori, and I want to tell you about one of my favorite pants in the Vuori lineup, the Sunday Performance Jogger. The fabric on this jogger is absolutely incredible. It's got a more tailored, modern fit, making them super versatile, and it has a zip pocket to secure your belongings. Whether you're lounging around the house or you're putting yourself through a tough workout in the gym, the Sunday has you covered. And that's why the Sunday Jogger is my everyday jogger.
Introducing the premium collection at Fanatics.com. Stylish fan gear for fashionable fans. Shop wear by Aaron Andrews, DKNY, Darius Rucker, Mitchell and Ness, and more. Fanatics.com, officially licensed everything.
Why pay over $100 a month for cable when it's half the cost for Fubo TV? Get all the channels you want on the only live TV streaming service rated number one in customer satisfaction by J.D. Power. Try free at FuboTV.com.
ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Ram Trucks. Xavier Scott coming up with the INT in the end zone. First year starter. And Illinois got the ball back. Down three scores. Luke Altmyer back in there. He took a big hit on a two-point conversion on the last drive. Altmyer moving out. The ball is tipped and lands incomplete. Second down and 10.
One of the big fellas almost coming up with it. Tony Dunn Jr. seeing the ball bounce around a little bit. Route by Washington. The closing speed of Kobe Bryant.
Bryant's first team all Big 12 last year with the PBU. Altmyer under pressure. Down he goes. The fifth sack for Kansas. And the second of the night for Jeremy Robinson.
Returning starter is Robinson. And he is a solid pass rusher, is what the staff told us. We're certainly seeing that tonight in, on full display.
A window and has Isaiah Williams for a first down just inside the 40. Fourth catch for Williams.
Excellent throw. The offensive line giving Altmyer the time necessary to work the pocket and allow the route to develop down the field. An accurately thrown ball. They said they wanted to get the ball in Williams' hands a lot more this week. We'll certainly target him, targeting to him that way.
Four catches, 75 yards. For the two-time captain. Altmyer chased again. Checks down underneath. Nothing doing. Reggie Love erased for a loss.
And luckily, he missed the ball. Otherwise, he was going to be, he's tackled for a loss.
That's incomplete.
Hey.
got time. Finds his man. And the midfield is Beatty. A first down for Illinois, a gain of a dozen.
It'll be the first catch of the year for Beatty. Didn't have a catch in last week's game. And we'll call you calling his name tonight. Actually, third catch. Where have I been?
Love goes wide. Design quarterback run. Altmeyer broke off a 72-yard touchdown run earlier. Picks up nine. It sets up second and one.
What did the coaching staff tell us about Altmeyer?
He's fast.
More athletic than you give him credit for. I think Kansas may be falling asleep a little bit when they drop into coverage, not thinking that he's going to pull it down and run. And he's doing just that. You can't just assume that this young man is a pocket passer. He is 72-yard touchdown run to his credit.
Again to the air. Moves the pocket. Throws on the run. And he's got Love out of the backfield. Moves the chains.
Give him enough for a first down.
Now, there was a tipping point in this game where you started to wonder, would Illinois play some of its younger backs, maybe some of its younger wide receivers, but Kansas has held the door open.
Yeah, just enough. They got a foot in the door.
Tunnel screen. Dangerous throw. Isaiah Williams. And Illinois in the red zone. Kenny Logan brings him down.
How about the closing speed of Logan? My goodness. Identified who had the ball and was on the other side of the field. As Williams is trying to get to top speed, here comes Logan. And no way was he getting away. Number one, closing on number one.
Williams closing in on 100 yards receiving. Big 250-pound freshman Caden Fagan is in the game at running back. They feed him. And he muscles his way to about the 11-yard line. Andre, 6'3", 250 pounds, a sledgehammer. Now, the coaching staff said this guy could play tight end, linebacker, even defensive end, but they like him at running back.
Out of Illinois, the school, high school record for single-season rushing yards and touchdowns. There's a four-star big recruiting get for Illinois.
Top incoming recruit. Meyer tracked down from behind, and he gets maybe a yard. Flag down.
Richard Joyner with the tackle.
Illegal formation. More than four in the backfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Down by 18. They need to score quickly. And the approach, and we talked about this, the approach would be what happened before halftime, where you're just right at the line of scrimmage, up tempo, letting Luke Altmeyer operate quickly.
Williams in motion, second and 11. Altmeyer finding Williams, takes a big hit, flag down. This could be targeting a receiver in the act of making a catch is defenseless. Kobe Bryant was the one who made the tackle, and the question now is, was it forcible contact above the shoulders with an indicator?
Going to be close, really close.
Personal foul, defense charging a defenseless player. This foul is under further review.
You see exactly. Just shoulder to the chest.
Where did he get him? Now that upward thrust is an indicator. Williams, at that point, is still a defenseless player.
Yeah.
I think this is going to be targeting. Makes contact
with a helmet.
And that is forcible. To me, this checks the boxes. It's a tough spot, Andre. Guys are playing it at full speed. We see it all the time, but the rule is in place. It's a player safety rule for a reason. And if this is confirmed, you lose Kobe Bryant, one of the best corners in the Big 12, for the first half of your next game.
Along with Austin Booker, who's already out of the game and will miss the first half of next week's game against Nevada. That game's on the road.
After review, personal foul, charging number two of the defense. Number two is disqualified for the remainder of the game. So half of this is penalty, automatic, first down.
So Bryant, the first-team All-Conference DB last year, who had four picks a season ago and had one last week, is out of the game. Austin Booker, who had two sacks tonight, is out of the game. And Illinois now with a first and goal, looking to draw closer. Altmyer's got room to run, has the angle, and has the end zone.
Nice job by Altmyer surveying the field. Nothing's there. And here, this close, you see the goal line. Go ahead and get that nose in there. We're going to go for two here.
A two-point conversion makes this an 11-point game.
A lot of people tuning in. Fingers crossed right here.
You don't say. Altmyer shovels to Love, reaching, and he's got it.
He actually fell on the goal line, so it's good.
Illinois making this interesting. They need a field goal, a touchdown with another two-point conversion to pull even. Still 8:08 to go. Altmyer with a second rushing TD.
J'adore. Dior.
At Macy's, the fragrance destination.
My name is Robbie, but most know me from my McDojo-like presence online. I wasn't always so great with martial arts, though. I learned martial arts to defend myself. I was born with a cleft lip and palate that caused me to be teased mercilessly as a child because of my scars. Operation Smile is an organization that provides not only surgeries, but pre- and post-care for children who were born with a cleft lip and palate. And so many kids are waiting for their chance for a new smile. Learn how you can help by visiting OperationSmile.org today.
Take a look at this heart. It's the one I'm gonna use to love.
Nice footwork.
Man, you're lucky. Watching live sports never used to be this easy. Now you can stream all your games like it's nothing.
Yes! That's what I'm talking about!
Oh, here he comes!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Running up and down that field looks tough.
It's a pitch.
Get way more into what you're into when you stream on the Xfinity 10G network.
Flex left. Flex right. And double flex. Find your inner flex with Duluth Double Flex Ballroom Denim. Only at Duluth Trading.
My schedule's pretty jam-packed these days.
I've got two.
We know three birthday parties on Saturday, and Sunday, that's my me time.
How's that look?
Works for me.
Works for me.
Do you struggle to put on your shoes when you leave the house? It's time to call an Audible. With New Max Cushioning Hands-Free Skechers Slip-Ins, it's easy. I just step in and go without touching my shoes.
Tony, where are you going? My mom's coming over.
False start. Try New Max Cushioning Hands-Free Skechers Slip-Ins.
J'adore. Dior. At Macy's, the fragrance destination.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Ram Trucks.
Couple of pretty good Kansas running backs in the 60s. First, Gale Sayers, the Kansas Comet. John Riggins, another Hall of Famer. And in fact, Riggins was the running back for Kansas the last time Kansas and Illinois played. That was September 21st, 1968. Kansas won that game 47-7 at Illinois.
Pretty good players, right?
A couple of Hall of Famers.
Two pretty good players. Riggins would just run you over.
Mm-hmm.
And Gale Sayers could make you miss in a phone booth.
Gale Sayers is one of those players where you wonder what if the injuries didn't cut his career short. What he could have been. And he was so good in the time that he played.
UFC 293 tomorrow night from Sydney, Australia. The main event features the last stylebender, Israel Adesanya, defending his middleweight belt against Sean Strickland. At 6'4", Israel has crazy reach. The main card begins at 10 Eastern on pay-per-view. Prelims, 8 Eastern on ESPN News, ESPN Deportes, and ESPN Plus. Go to ESPNplus.com/PPV to order the fights. Andre, you'd love to throw to a guy like Israel at 6'4".
Absolutely. 6'4", corner of the end zone. He'd be a red zone specialist on the squad with me, throwing him lob shots all night.
Jalen Daniels faking Akis out of his shoes and picking up about 16 on the play for a first down.
That was Neil. Neil had hit earlier in the game and hadn't been back for a while. It was their other back in Highshell.
And Daniels throwing blocks upfield.
Yeah. Telling you, that trick play is coming at some point where they hand it to Daniels and a pass after that. Just setting it up all night long.
Neil hobbling a bit after the play. 10 carries, 120 yards rushing, and a touchdown tonight.
Boy, the patience there. Nice shot with the patience. He's letting blocks kind of set themselves. He's just picking around, finding a nice soft spot in the middle, and a big gain on first down.
Andre, it's a nice change of pace, right? Neil, you're all around back and do a little bit of everything.
Yeah, when you need to basically kind of run the clock a little bit. It's nice luxury to have an offensive line that's experienced and a Devin Neal behind him who's just kind of having his way tonight. And you can't forget Highshaw either.
Now they keep it on the ground. And they keep it with Highshaw still going. And finally dropped from behind by Gabe Akis.
I think he heard us.
41 of Illinois.
He heard us up here talking about it. Hey, you're giving a little bit too much credit to Devin Neal when it's me in the game.
He got lost in there, and then
nobody could find him. They have as good a 1-2 punch as there is in the Big 12.
And you know what? 3-4 aren't bad either.
No.
Duffy was a 1,000-yard rusher a couple of years ago at Buffalo. Savion Morrison has some breakaway speed at the Nebraska transfer.
And Lachlan, we mentioned earlier, already with a touchdown.
Oh, and two quarterbacks who can run a little.
No doubt.
Daniels chased by Newton. He won't get away. Johnny Newton with the sack. The All-American.
Yeah, got a little greedy there trying to wait for
the receiver to come open down the field. They max protected, only released two guys out in the pattern. And he's trying to buy some time to let one of these tight ends come open. Just couldn't get themselves free, and that's when Newton got home. Big Johnny Newton.
He is projected to be a first-round pick. You look at the mock drafts out there, anywhere from top 10 to top 15, and the season has just begun. He has a chance to improve his stock big time. Big deal when he and Randolph return to school. Big hole. Highshaw powers inside the 30.
A 7-yard loss. Made it 2nd and 17. Hey, no problem. Just give me the rock. Big, big gain by number 20, Daniel Highshaw.
Running short of the line of gain. It is 3rd down.
Oh, that's close. I thought he had it.
I don't know about the spot. They marked
exactly.
Just shy of the 30. It looked like he got inside the 30. Crowd does not love the spot.
Yeah, I thought he had the first down easily. Easily had it. Big down here for Illinois.
Lance Leipold calls a timeout. They may challenge this.
Timeout. Kansas. Split first and a half. It'll be 30 seconds in length.
I wonder if they look at this upstairs.
Let's take a look ourselves. See if Highshaw actually got there. I thought he had it easily.
The line to gain is the 30-yard line of Illinois.
Kansas is challenging the ruling on the field that the runner was short of the line of gain.
Knee touches, but where was the knee when he...
Where is the
ball when the knee touched? And I think he clearly has the first down.
I'm with you, Andre.
Across the 30-yard line.
I know, I guess.
Where's the ball when the knee goes down? The knee goes down with the 30. Right there.
Yep.
Yeah, that's a first down.
So close already that if they move it, I think it's going to give him the first down. That man can coach some football, can't he?
Wisconsin Whitewater, 5 Division III championships. Goes to Buffalo, resurrects that program. And in his last 3 years there, that was the high renaissance of Buffalo football.
You want to know how special he is?
After a review, the ruling on the field stands as call. Kansas has lost. The challenge will also be a timeout.
Oh, my goodness. But there's so many Buffalo players on this roster that they left Buffalo to follow Lance Leipold to Lawrence, Kansas. That's when you know you've got a special coach. And most are contributing.
Look at the center, Nowitzki, McDuffie, part of the backfield. There are others. So, the ruling on the field stands. What they saw upstairs was not indisputable. And it's 3rd down. I would think up 11, this might be 4 down territory. Probably is. And they need about a 0.5 yard.
I need a new pair of glasses, obviously.
Casey in motion. Daniels gets the snap. He's in trouble. And he goes down for a loss.
Just kind of slipped. Feet went from under him and just tapped down by Alec Bryant.
And now it's 4th down. You're really pushing your kicker's range. Now this may be a go for it for Kansas.
And with Illinois, those big guys along the defensive line, got to worry about is the hard count. Stay on side. You don't want to just give the first down to Kansas. You know, you're jumping with a Jalen Daniels hard count.
McDuffie's the running back. He gets the call. Trying to fight through the teeth of that defense. He won't get there. Illinois takes over. So it started with a spot. Kansas didn't get the spot. It looked like Highshaw had the first down. Instead, it was 3rd and 1. Illinois gets the stop. 3:33 to go. 4th quarter. Still got a little drama in Lawrence.
The beach has always been there for us. As an oasis. Somewhere you can escape to. So it's time we were there for it. That's why Corona's helping clean 100 beaches by 2025. It's the first step in our fight against plastic pollution. To join us, visit coronausa.com.
Hi, we're Visible, the wireless company with nothing to hide. Get unlimited 5G data powered by Verizon for $25 a month, every month. Sorry, hidden fees, we're just not into you. Sometimes the choice is just Visible. Switch today at Visible.com.
Let's unretire.
I got a few plays left, how about you?
Hey, Grandpa!
Grandpa?
Let's go!
I still got it.
We thought we could play. This wasn't no bear. It was like a bear squatch.
Dad, what's a bear squatch?
It's a cross between a bear and a sass. It's made up. He's usually sleeping.
He'll never sleep again.
At Domino's, our newest stuffed cheesy bread is loaded with pepperoni. Frankly, we're kind of embarrassed we didn't think of adding pepperoni sooner. But better late than never? Try irresistible new pepperoni stuffed cheesy bread. It's the perfect mouth-watering side for pepperoni lovers. Only at Domino's.
Pano AI chooses T-Mobile for Business for 5G solutions. Because T-Mobile helps Pano AI innovate so they can stop the spread of wildfires. Now's the time to see what America's largest 5G network can do for your business.
Goldfish, can I get a handful?
Sure.
Happy?
Go for the handful.
Give me something.
This game is one of the biggest of the year.
Huge brand names, iconic colors.
Texas, Alabama, Saturday on ESPN.
UFC 293. Buy it on ESPNplus.com/PPV.
Big 12 now, only on ESPN Plus. Tomorrow's featured matchups. BYU hosting Southern Utah, West Virginia home for Duquesne, and TCU will take on Nichols. If you're a Big 12 fan, gotta have it. Sign up at ESPNplus.com/Big 12 now. Second half of this game with replay reviews, with targeting, with stoppages. The game has lost all flow, and that has affected one team more than the other, namely Kansas.
Illinois, to their credit, they needed to step up defensively. They got a stop, and they have the ball.
Altmyer is hit and taken down. Kansas last week had 9 TFLs. Today, that's 6 sacks.
You can say, well, I saw it coming last week. Kansas played Missouri State. Well, this is a Big Ten team that had a very good season a year ago and a lot of experience coming back.
After the sack by J.B. Brown, Altmyer looking for an escape route. It's not there, and he goes out of bounds. It'll bring up a third and long.
Chrysler's had, he's got his hands full over there. It was Booker earlier. Now they're just kind of rotating around. Patrick Joyner, he's been over there. Dylan Brooks has been there. It's tough. They need to get some help in the form of a tight end or a running back to help their right tackle, Zach Crystal.
What does Illinois draw up? What does Brian Borland, Kansas's D coordinator, draw up? He was out last week with an illness he did not coach. Altmyer escaping, looking downfield. Throws, nearly picked, fourth down. Flag down. Another one, too.
I'm going to call targeting again. Oh, ineligible receiver downfield is what the call is going to be. Maybe somebody hit Altmyer late.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense number 73. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Josh Geske, the right guard. A little bit too far downfield, big fella.
Fourth and forever here. Fourth and 16. You got to call it, Anish?
Maybe throw it up to Casey Washington like Luke Altmyer did last week.
We'll find Isaiah Williams somewhere and let him catch the catch and run when you're this deep.
Kansas drops eight. Altmyer down the middle, caught for a first down near midfield. Griffin Moore, the fifth-year senior.
Backed up a little bit too far, just gave free releases to the receivers, and the offensive line does his job. That gave Moore enough time to find the first down marker and then show his numbers to the quarterback.
We come up on 2 minutes to play. Illinois's got two timeouts. Altmyer into traffic. Kansas picks it off.
The ruling on the field is an interception. First down, Kansas.
Lassiter with the pick.
Quinton Lassiter, son of Kwame. Two straight games, two interceptions for the senior from Chandler, Arizona.
Might as well be me.
A truck is a tool, but a Ram is life. It's the let's load up the ATVs life. The my kids play way too many sports life. The let's find a secret spot to fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 4,000 retail consumer cash allowance on most 2023 Ram 1500 trucks. See your Ram dealer today.
You know when a melty grilled cheese sounds so good, but so does a bacony burger with creamy peppercorn ranch. And you couldn't possibly choose because brain no work too good when tummy empty. Sonic Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheese Burger Deal for $3.99.
When your child starts getting into everything, you may need a little help. So Duracell created the only lithium coin batteries with a bitter coating to help discourage swallowing.
These Cheez-It Puffs are so cheesy, airy, and puffy. How'd you do it?
With the Puffterizer 5000, anything can be craveably puffy.
Cheez-It Puffed. Defy your cheese expectations.
First, Subway refreshed their ingredients. Then they created the perfect menu of subs, the Subway series. And now they're slicing their meats fresh.
Wow. Subway works almost as hard as I do.
We'll talk about your ego later.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today?
Picking up the Duralast brakes I ordered online this morning.
Right now, you can save 15% when you buy a set of Duralast pads with rotors.
Isn't it absolutely bonkers that you can walk into a store, hand someone a piece of plastic, and they will willingly hand over Reese's Cups? Forget flying cars. This is it. We're at the pinnacle. Try big cups. They're stuffed with more stuff.
Shelves. Shelves that know what taste buds want. Shelves smart enough to see. Sense. React. Restock. So caramel swirl is always there for the taking.
Two games into the season, Quinton Lassiter's got two picks. His older brother played at Kansas. Dad, Kwame, the late Kwame Lassiter, played at KU in the early 90s, spent a decade in the NFL. That young man came in when Kobe Bryant was ejected for targeting, comes up with a pick, and Kansas less than 2 minutes away from a 2-0 start. Last year they started 5-0. Andre, this is a team, as Illinois calls a timeout.
Timeout, Illinois, the second and a half, 30 seconds in late.
This Kansas team was picked ninth out of 14 in the Big 12. As you look at the Saturday slate with Oklahoma hosting SMU, LSU looking to bounce back, TCU looking to bounce back as well. All the games on ESPN+. 9 out of 14 doesn't sound great. It's the first time since the Big 12 did away with divisions that Kansas wasn't picked last.
Wow.
When you watch the team tonight with your own eyes, are you buying nine or
no.
are you going up?
I'm going up. I mean, their stock is certainly on the rise, and it's not just one side of the ball. We knew they had the preseason Big 12 player of the year, offensive player of the year, Jalen Daniels, but the defense is what I think has surprised me the most. The sacks, the getting at, stopping the run, getting after the quarterback, the forced turnovers. It's a complete team from top to bottom.
Another timeout called.
Illinois, the third and final charge will be a 30-second and late.
Illinois out of timeouts. We've seen balance tonight from Kansas as Randolph, part of the law firm, is down. Jayhawks almost 540 yards of offense, almost 260 on the ground, 280 through the air. And Andre, before you looked at Kansas's schedule four years ago, you could re-rack that for almost any year, post-Mangino, pre-Lance Leipold, and you would try to pick out a couple of wins. Hey, maybe the FCS school, maybe the non-conference game against the team out of Conference USA.
Yeah.
Now you start to go down the schedule and you say, well, okay, maybe there's not a full confidence game here, but they can hang with that one. They can win that one. They can win that one.
There's a stretch.
Kansas is no longer a gimme.
No, there's no gimmies here. And anybody on that schedule watching tonight, you're going to have your hands full with this Kansas team.
A first down by McDuffie.
They run it well. They throw it well. They defend. Special teams are solid, and they're well coached and disciplined. So buckle up. But there is a stretch of games in that schedule that starts at with BYU and then Texas. And you got Oklahoma State in there, Oklahoma, Iowa State.
But they beat Oklahoma State last year. That was the game that got them bowl eligible.
This year it's in Stillwater.
Now you look at a Baylor team. I think we had high hopes for Baylor. Baylor lost to Texas State last week.
I didn't see that coming.
Kansas in victory formation.
Well, gentlemen, they also have Lance Leipold and a staff that's been together for a long time. The entire staff, 10 position coaches back from last year, 91% of their offense, 82% of their defense, and Lance Leipold has never changed. I called games that he was coaching at Wisconsin, Whitewater, Buffalo, and now Kansas. And I talked to him before the game. I said, Coach, you've never changed, huh? He goes, what's the sense of changing? You coach football, you don't need to have an ego doing this.
He's put together not just a great staff, but he has kept them together. And when we talked to Brian Borland and Andy Kolarnicki, they've mentioned how much they enjoyed working for Lance Leipold.
Yeah. I mean, you got coaches that love it, players that are following him. I think something special is being built right here in Lawrence, Kansas. And I'm glad we got a chance to see it up close and personal tonight.
The last time Kansas started 2-0 in back-to-back seasons, 2008 and 2009. It's been a minute. Kansas is 2-0 in back-to-back seasons. The Jayhawks, an 11-point win against the Fighting Illini. They'll get Nevada next. The Blackhawk jerseys work tonight, but it's more than just the fashion. There's a lot of substance behind what this team does. Paul Carcaterra with the head coach of the 2-0 Jayhawks.
Coach, in that second half, where were you tested the most?
Well, you know, I think, you know, some penalties and adversity. They got the momentum a little bit. We turned the ball over. We weren't getting a lot of pressure on the quarterback, but we got some turnovers when we needed it. And really proud of the resiliency of this football team.
You return 91% of your offense. You have 540 yards of offense tonight. What's the strength of this unit?
I think the strength of the unit, I think our staff does a great job of spreading the ball around and utilizing everybody in a lot of personnel groupings and get a lot of touches to different guys. And guys are accepting that role, and it's a lot of fun, and they've embraced it. And, of course, we've got a quarterback that's making some plays.
When you took the job in 2021, the stadium didn't look like this in Lawrence. What's this like for you and the staff and the players?
Well, it's awesome, and we really appreciate the support that's come out here. Proud of our players for really embracing what we've been about since we've been here.